World Wrestling Federation. In sports entertainment.
This week on Wrestling Challenge, the debut of the Caribbean legend Savio Vega, plus the exciting tag team combination of Techno Team 2000. And we'll hear from the WWF Women's Champion, Alundra Blaze, all that and much more this week. Can't wait to see our very first competitor.
We have got returns, or we have got debuts, but wait until you see the boy toy. This guy is on top of his game.
And here he comes, ladies and gentlemen. What the faces! Listen to them. For Shawn Michaels. The supreme fighting machine, the 6'8", 330-pound comma.
Well, the winner of that one could win it all. Look at that. He's got it.
He is an electrifying athlete. Perhaps the most truly gifted athlete in the entire World Wrestling Federation. And if you don't believe it, just ask him.
Boy, he's cocky. And when you have the ability that Shawn Michaels has, hey, you're flaunted. I don't blame him.
Barry Horowitz will challenge Shawn Michaels. This is our first opportunity here on Challenge to see Michaels in action. Side headlock applied by Horowitz, and Michaels cannot underestimate the wrestling ability of Barry Horowitz.
A real ring veteran, and how ironic is it, Jim Ross, that just when Shawn Michaels comes off the injured list, the champ goes on it.
We'll have more on the diesel situation later in this broadcast. Quick go behind and the counter move there by Barry Horowitz.
Nice leverage.
Look at the great quickness and speed of Shawn Michaels.
And how ironic is it that it was Psycho Sid who put both of these guys out of commission?
Of course, Gorilla referring to the fact that Psycho Sid put Diesel on the shelf as a result of the big power bomb at In Your House. And then, of course, it has been well documented, the damage after several power bombs to Shawn Michaels. That was the day after WrestleMania 11.
But he is young. He's got those recuperative powers. This guy's back, and I would venture to say at least 100%.
Look who's coming down the aisle.
Wait a minute.
Mr. Moneybags himself, the Donald Trump of the WWF, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. Looks like he's got a fistful of bills there.
Well, Shawn finally got a look at him out of the corner of his eye. He's inviting him in.
Well, why is DiBiase here to make an offer?
Highly unlikely.
DiBiase coming closer to ringside, and those European uppercuts finding their mark on Barry Horowitz.
Oh,
there's
look at that.
There's a jawbreaker by Horowitz on Shawn Michaels into the side headlock situation again. Michaels leapfrogging Horowitz, and Horowitz returns it in time. And sliding outside.
Oh, look at DiBiase. There's a noise there.
DiBiase. And DiBiase.
Oh, he took the money.
Michaels just took, it looked like a $100 bill from the Million Dollar Man. He's stuffing that money down into his tights, and DiBiase doesn't like it.
And he didn't have to do a thing for it.
Scoop slam by Shawn Michaels on Horowitz here. And Michaels now, who will take a lot of chances going up to the top.
Boy, he doesn't waste any time. And look at the agility, the quickness. Look out.
The elbow right off the top. None doing any better than that.
Well, he could have ended it right there, and he chose him to.
DiBiase beside himself. He lost some money there. And there's that super kick. It's knocked a lot of them out, including King Kong Bundy.
Oh, he's going to give the 100 away.
He's tipping Barry Horowitz. Michaels with the arrogant three count. Shawn Michaels is victorious, and DiBiase is irate.
DiBiase beside himself. Boy, did things turn around bad for him in this one.
Shawn Michaels, who indeed is looking forward to meeting any member of the million-dollar corporation, including Psycho Sid, and that one-on-one matchup is going to happen sooner than later.
Sooner or later, it's going to go down, and I want to be on hand when it does.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's so many exciting things going on in the WWF. The return of Shawn Michaels.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. And well, due to Diesel's injury, some incredible changes are in store for the World Tour de Force next weekend. That's right, this Friday at Nassau Coliseum, this Saturday at Madison Square Garden, 1 week from tonight at the Meadowlands Arena. As a matter of fact, let's go back to Superstars yesterday when Todd Pettengill, my buddy, got the scoop from Jeff Tunney himself.
You're kidding.
All right, well, I got it all down, but... All right, I gotta go. I'm on. I gotta go. Thank you.
You are not going to believe this. Just got off the phone, President Jack Tunney's office.
Huge weekend, right? Nassau Coliseum, Madison Square Garden, the Meadowlands, World Wrestling Federation live, right? Check this out. Jack Tunney confirmed it. Who's filling in for Diesel at the Meadowlands and Madison Square Garden? Before I tell you that, unbelievable news. Jack Tunney has added yet another match at the Nassau Coliseum this Friday night. Check this out. Psycho Sid has been added to the card. He will meet Bam Bam Bigelow one-on-one. And when you hear my other news, folks, you're going to know it's not going to be a great weekend for Psycho Sid. Trust me. Another individual has been added to the 20-man Battle Royal at the Nassau Coliseum. An individual has been named to replace Big Daddy Cool Diesel, the big cage match Saturday at the most famous arena in the world, Madison Square Garden. Plus, an individual has been named to replace Big Daddy Cool Diesel at the Meadowlands, the tag match. And guess what? It's not three different guys. Steph, it's one man. The one and only Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Is that unbelievable?
You're kidding. Shawn Michaels all three nights?
What a weekend. Shawn Michaels added to the 20-man Battle Royal at the Nassau Coliseum. He will replace Big Daddy Cool Diesel in that cage match at Madison Square Garden and the tag matchup at the Meadowlands. It's unbelievable. I got to go. I got to call Jim Ross so we can get it on the Superstar line. I'll talk to you later.
What a scoop for Todd Pettengill, huh? And what a show of friendship on the part of Shawn Michaels. Now, tickets are available right now at the respective box offices and at Ticketmaster, 212-307-7171, this Friday at Nassau Coliseum, this Saturday at Madison Square Garden, 1 week from tonight at Meadowlands Arena. See it live.
There's a lot more action still to come, ladies and gentlemen, including we will finally hear from Jerry the King Lawler. Lawler will answer Bret Hart's challenge. That is still to come. Don't go away. Welcome back, everyone. Jim Ross and Gorilla Monsoon back with you. Thanks again for being with us. We are ready to take a look at the White Angel, Hakushi.
From Japan, weighing 235
pounds. Hakushi coming to the ring, of course, by his follower, Shinja.
Who's become more than a follower of late, Jim.
I'm a little interested in what's in that bag there in the center of the ring. Bill Payne will challenge Hakushi this week. Of course, Hakushi was defeated by Bret the Hitman Hart at In Your House on Mother's Day. A phenomenal event. A tremendous one-on-one matchup that Hakushi did indeed lose and certainly has had many sleepless nights thinking about it.
Well, not hard to understand that. Of course, in the Japanese culture, losing face, a very big deal.
Hakushi wants another chance at meeting the Hitman Bret Hart I've been informed that this time he says it's going to be different as he looks into the bag here.
It's like a rice sack.
Like a little toe sack from Oklahoma.
Oh, come on.
And the head of Bret Hart. Well, you talk about symbolism. Hakushi with the head of Bret Hart coming out of that bag. And perhaps a symbolic gesture of things to come as far as Hakushi is concerned. And you can hear the crowd here already chanting, "We want Bret," and so do we. We want Bret to step into the ring with Jerry the King Lawler.
Of course, the same night that the Hitman defeated Hakushi was also one of the Hitman's biggest losses, one of the most embarrassing moments in the entire career of the Excellence of Execution as he fell to that self-professed King Jerry Lawler.
Nice arm drag takeover by Bill Payne, but Gorilla, we must point out that Jerry Lawler would have lost to Bret Hart. At least that's my opinion.
No question.
If Hakushi and Shinja had not intervened and interfered in that contest.
But it's not going to say that in a record book, Jim Ross.
Well, you're right
it's
about
it. It's going to say that Lawler defeated Bret Hart. That's all.
That's a very good point, and that's exactly what Bret has been thinking about day and night since Mother's Day. And Hakushi with a knife-edge chop there on Bill Payne. And here comes the Irish whip to the near side. And watch Hakushi.
Ooh, look at the round off.
Nice handspring elbow there by Hakushi.
Bret has indicated to me, Jim Ross, that he will do anything to get Lawler inside the squared circle again.
Well, we're going to hear Lawler's reply to that challenge. Hopefully, Lawler... Oh, Hakushi didn't find anybody at home that time. Hip-hop takeover. Jerry Lawler allegedly will answer that challenge for all of us right here this week, and we will bring it.
Oh, wow.
Wow. We'll bring it to you.
What right
here
shot.
In the arc. Shot it deep. As a matter of fact, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have those words from Jerry Lawler right after this match. So be sure and stay with us as Hakushi takes the legs from Bill Payne.
I don't think that Lawler is going to be too anxious to climb back in there with Bret. He got his clock cleaned, you know.
Bret said he would do anything, any stipulation, any kind of match, anywhere, anytime.
What will the devious mind? Oh, look at this. Good night.
High impact move right off the second rope. I tell you something, Hakushi, and there's a look at Shinja. Very, very athletic. You've got to be impressed with his athletic skills. And as we said, and Gorilla pointed out earlier, his loss to Bret Hart at In Your House was very humiliating for this athlete. He wants another shot at Bret. And a drop kick.
Wow.
Hakushi has said emphatically through his follower, Shinja, it'll be differently this time. That's a nice move. The leg is hooked, and it's over.
Well, you know, he polished him off with that move, but there was about a half a dozen before then that could have did the job as well.
The tattooed Hakushi. Looking forward to another opportunity with Bret the Hitman Hart as we now update you on the Hart Lawler. I agree with the Gorilla when we come back. It's the debut of Techno Team 2000. And welcome back, everyone. We are excited about the WWF Challenge debut of Techno Team 2000. You see Travis on your left, that's Troy on your right.
Troy,
we are ready to see this exciting young tag team girl that has a huge amount of potential.
Quite outstanding is the word that comes to mind, Jim Ross. Two guys put together a team. They've got continuity, they tell me. I haven't seen these guys in action as yet, but hey, talk about two college graduates looking to make a name for themselves here in the World Wrestling Federation. I might want to put some money on these guys.
They'll be taking on Bob Cook, the veteran from Florida, and Howard Nally. Also want to say a very special hello to all of our fans and friends watching us on Sunday on Fox 5 in New York City. Collar elbow tie-up. That's Bob Cook and Troy starting it out for the respective teams here.
It's going to get hot in the Big Apple this Saturday, Jim Ross, I'll tell you that.
Oh, that's the big event in Madison Square Garden, no doubt about that. And I tell you, well, good move there by Troy, reversing the hammerlock on Bob Cook. You talk about huge events. You know, we talk so much about the King of the Ring and other huge events, but nothing can be bigger than the Triple Header Weekend. Good arm drag takeover coming to the greater New York City area, Long Island, New Jersey, beginning this Friday. This Friday,
Oh, there's Cook. Got him rolled up there. Got a one count out of him.
Nassau Coliseum this Friday. It will be electrifying in the Nassau Coliseum.
Well, you know, there's a huge 20-man battle royal there. Oh, my. Good move there. A huge 20-man battle royal in Nassau this Friday night. And Shawn Michaels has entered that battle royal.
Well, Shawn Michaels, whenever there's a match going on that's unusual, that's going to create interest, that's going to demand the best in the WWF, Shawn wants to be there.
And listen to this, Gorilla. On that big card in Nassau on Friday night, this match has been signed. It will be, folks, and grab a hold of your seats on this one. In Nassau this Friday night, Bam Bam Bigelow goes one-on-one with Psycho Sid.
Well, of course, that match coming to pass because of the injury to the champ, Big Daddy Cool on the shelf. And, hey, you know, everybody figured that sooner or later there was going to be a match between Bam Bam and Psycho Sid. But who would have ever thought it would come this quick?
It's going to happen Friday night in Nassau. Plus, the bad guy, Razor Ramon, takes on Double J Jeff Jarrett. Now, the folks, the Intercontinental title is going to be on the line in Nassau this Friday night. And the roadie is suspended in a cage. Oh, nice move there.
Smart decision on the part of President Jack Tunney to hang that roadie where he belongs, about 30 feet above the ring. Keep the guy out of the way.
That's going to be Friday night in Nassau at the Coliseum. Great seats are available at all Ticketmaster outlets, they tell me. Still some real good seats available. And, of course, the big event, too, coming to Madison Square Garden will be this Saturday night. We'll be telling you more about the big event coming to the Garden. And also a reminder that WWF in the Meadowlands a week from tonight.
Well, the Brendan Byrne Arena, that will be on fire as well. Hey, if you don't have anything to do on the weekend, or if you do have something to do, cancel it, because nothing like this is going to go down for quite some time.
Tag made as Troy tags in Travis. And
oh, look at that double leapfrog.
Nice move there by Techno Team 2000. Cross body by Travis. And got a near fall out of the situation. A little cheap shot there.
Oh, look out.
By Howard Nally. And look from behind. Oh, right hand.
Well, it figures Techno 2000 coming here to the World Wrestling Federation. Got to be excited. They're going to be making a few mistakes. This is where you get it out of your system before you get in there with the real heavy guns.
Nice suplex by Cook. They try to get a pinning situation again, but Travis able to power out of it, a tag mate.
Travis might do good to, that's Troy.
Well, that's Travis.
That's Travis. He might do good to get a haircut so he can see where he's going.
I figured you might say something like that.
Well, you know those guys with the long hair, they give me a negative attitude. I'm jealous.
Snapmare takeover.
But they're showing me something here.
Oh, good athleticism. This is a fine young team. Well, I'll tell you something. I can't wait. I am planning on attending those big events in the greater New York City area Friday night in the Nassau Coliseum. Now, what a great arena for WWF competition.
Well, you stay right there in the Big Apple, Jim Ross, and you can hit all three at the same time and maybe even catch Phantom of the Opera as well.
And nice move.
Oh, yes.
Right off the top. Good move there by Troy. And the Techno Team 2000 wins it. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, it's Friday night in the Nassau Coliseum. This Saturday in Madison Square Garden. And 1 week from tonight in the Meadowlands.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry of 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in stores now.
Preferred stock. The extra smooth cologne for an extra special man. Preferred stock. What preferred men prefer. From the House of Stetson.
Ladies and gentlemen, something that has gone undaunted in our society for a number of years is the type of music that our youth listen to. I'm going to require that they listen to classical music. Beethoven and Bach, that's what would it boon their intelligence. This rock and roll garbage has had a deleterious effect on our society for a number of years. Just look at the crime rate. It should be abolished immediately.
So should you, paranoid Bob. Give me a break. Aren't we in enough trouble?
Ladies and gentlemen, still to come, the debut of Savio Vega. And we will hear from the WWF Women's Champion, Alundra Blaze. Still to come. Don't go away. Welcome back, everyone. We're going to take a quick look at the WWF Champion Diesel, whose rehabilitation for his elbow injury, Gorilla, is going quite well.
Boy, it certainly is. We're going to see how the injury occurred. We're going to hear from the champ himself and also the noted doctor, Jim Andrews.
My elbow there, and then when he gave me the power bomb, I thought I broke my arm there for a second.
Diesel was unfortunately powerbombed the other night. And when he came down, he landed right on his injured elbow. And when he was dropped, he landed right on that. And he ruptured his bursal sac, which caused a lot of bleeding. And he ruptured part of the tendon insertion to this part of his elbow where you see the little fragment and bone spur. At surgery, we made an incision from about there all the way down to about here. We repaired the tendon partial tear, and we evacuated the blood clot that was there, and we took out the bursal sac that had been ruptured. So we anticipate a good recovery. This gentleman has been an excellent patient. He's very intelligent. He's been through injuries before in all of his different athletic careers, and he's well motivated and is on his way to recovery as we speak.
Well, I had an elbow injury, and I saw the miracles he did with Lex Luger's arm, and I think that without a doubt, just from word of mouth around athletes in the country, I think he's considered by all of us as the number one orthopedic man in the country.
And as you know, our American Sports Medicine Institute is housed across the street. We're very proud of that research facility, which is a for nonprofit public foundation devoted to research and education in sports medicine. We're very involved in the biomechanical aspects of various sports, particularly the overhead throwing sports, not only in enhancement of performance, but particularly important to us in the prevention of injuries. Well, as you know, Diesel's quite tall. In fact, when I first looked at him, I was glad it wasn't his shoulder or his neck I had to examine. It was his elbow, which put his elbow right at eye level for me.
Well, obviously the champ in good hands as he repaired, Dr. Andrews said that he completely repaired that bursted bursar, allowing all that synovial fluid to flow out of there and caused a spur in there, but the champ will be back in action before we know it.
No doubt about it, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll keep you updated on Diesel and everything that's going on in the WWF on the WWF Superstar line. That's 1-900-737-4-WWF. Of course, we're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's only $1.49 a minute, and kids, you got to be at least 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling.
And I know, Jim Ross, that you're on the horn every day with the champ, and you are keeping us all abreast as to what's going on. That's what makes that option six such a hot one.
And ladies and gentlemen, of course, Diesel will be back in action prior to the King of the Ring competition. He's in that big tag team matchup when he and Bam Bam Bigelow take on Psycho Sid and Tatanka, as Jean-Pierre Lafitte and Brian Walsh.
Walsh is getting hammered here big time.
Boy, this Lafitte is a very impressive athlete.
Slingshot maneuver there over the top rope.
I see.
Take the start, Johnny.
Yeah, no kidding. I see great things, Gorilla, for Jean-Pierre Lafitte in the upcoming months here in the WWF. You know, he has yet to be defeated here in the WWF, and that win-loss record speaks for itself.
Well, I want to see Pierre in there with some stiffer competition. I want to see him in there with a British Bulldog or with a Lex Luger or with a Bret the Hitman Hart. That'll tell me what he's got.
Cole Nelson attempted here by Brian Walsh, but not for long. Pierre is too big and too strong. You don't see this maneuver too much anymore.
No, you don't, and it's going to be interesting, Jim Ross, at the King of the Ring, that big tag matchup with Diesel and Bam Bam taking on Psycho Tatanka. Oh, wow, what a move that was. Is the champ going to be a little tentative, or is he going to open it up?
Well, I talk to him every day. WWF Champion Diesel, that is. And I can assure you, he's going to open it up. He's going to open it up prior to the King of the Ring. And by the time Diesel gets to Philadelphia, he is going to be a wild animal. I can assure you. I would not want to be in the shoes or moccasins, as you said last week, of the team of Psycho Sid and Tatanka. Rough face lock applied by Pierre. Jean-Pierre Lafitte
is just mauling this youngster.
O'Brien Walsh has got all tied up here and nowhere to go. But take the blunt of that 275-pounder. Those cross bodies right into the ropes by Pierre, who's completely disregarding the admonishment of the referee.
Mike Chiodo, the third man in the ring, got to exert himself a little bit here and hold Pierre back while he gets Mr. Walsh, who's all tied up at the moment.
Can't come to the phone. Brian, don't call me Joe Walsh. He's in trouble here. Life hasn't been good to him so far.
Oh, look at this.
And this is a high-impact slam. Wow. Tied him up, did Pierre. You got to wonder, is this guy wrestling with a handicap, or is that patch really necessary?
Well, I don't think the patch is necessary. I'm sure it's just a sign of defiance here that he's showing us. He's going back to when his ancestors were supposedly... Oh, look at this.
Oh!
That the United States government turned a blind eye toward the laments of his great-great-great-great ancestors.
Well,
this one, thankfully,
Walsh is a thankful it's over. Boy, Pierre, very, very impressive here this week. We expect great things from this young man, no doubt about it. Let's take you back to Raw. Vince McMahon interviewed the WWF Women's Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, we're excited about the Hall of Fame ceremonies to be held in Philadelphia. Saturday night, June 24th. What an impressive array of athletes to be honored.
The second annual induction ceremonies, and one of the greats from yesteryear, Antonino Rocca, the man with the flying feet.
Also, ladies and gentlemen, Polish power, Ivan Putski.
Ivan Putski with the patented Polish hammer knew how to put you away in a hurry.
And also the fabulous Moolah.
The Southern Belle who held the women's title the longest here in the WWF.
And the big cat himself, Ernie Ladd.
Who made the successful transformation from the National Football League into the World Wrestling Federation.
We hope you can be with us Saturday, June 24th in Philadelphia at the Marriott. One man that's and as long, ladies and gentlemen, as you're circling dates on your calendar, let us remind you that one of the most exciting weekends ever in the WWF will be coming to the Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale, Long Island this Friday night. Men on a Mission will be a part of the big 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal that will include such stars as the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, Owen Hart, Yokozuna, the WWF Tag Champions, will be in there as well, and so many others.
A who's who, a virtual who's who here in the World Wrestling Federation. Hey, what a matchup that's going to be.
Folks, don't forget that WWF Wrestling Challenge is being brought to you this week by Sega, makers of Genesis, Color Game Gear, Sega CD, and the fastest, coolest video games ever.
I'll tell you what, Jim Ross, they better have reinforced the ring for that 20-man over-the-top battle royal, or that thing will collapse.
Boy, there's going to be several pounds in the ring in the Nassau Coliseum on Friday night, and great seats are still available for that event. And, of course, this Saturday night, the superstars of the WWF will converge on the legendary, the hallowed halls of Madison Square Garden. And it was originally scheduled for Big Daddy Cool Diesel to meet Sid inside the steel cage. We all know that Diesel, unable to compete this weekend, but there will be a cage match in the Garden this Saturday night when Shawn Michaels takes on Psycho Sid, the man that tried to end Shawn Michaels' career.
Unbelievable event going down in Madison Square Garden, and how ironic is it, Jim Ross, that Shawn Michaels, after being put on the shelf by Psycho Sid, gets an opportunity because Psycho Sid put Big Daddy Cool on the shelf. And hey, both of these guys are going to be in that 15-foot-high steel cage, which, incidentally, not erected so much to keep these guys in, but perhaps to keep other corporate members out.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that steel cage match can be won by escaping the cage or by pinfall or submission. And oh, good move there.
Ooh, wow.
Big roundhouse kick there by Mo. I mean, really, you've got some battle scars to prove how rough a cage match can be. You've been in several of them in Madison Square Garden.
Well,
it's just going to be so special this Saturday night.
It is the toughest, most grueling, most dangerous match of all here in the World Wrestling Federation. This kind of match can terminate your career.
Also, from South Bronx, making his first appearance in Madison Square Garden, will be Savio Vega. Look at that cheap shot by Big Mabel.
Hey, Savio will have a big following in the Big Apple.
Well, Savio and the bad guy Razor Ramon are going to try to win the WWF Tag Team Championship from Yokozuna and Owen Hart this Saturday night in the Garden. What a special 3 days it's going to be for all the wonderful WWF fans in Long Island, in New York,
New Jersey, Pennsylvania.
It's going to be great.
All those three states, they all come together there. And this is, look at this.
Look out. Well, Morales just got belly-to-belly big time by the 515-pounder. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what an opportunity for you and your family to see the superstars of the WWF live this Friday night, Nassau Coliseum, this Saturday, Madison Square Garden, and a week from tonight, oh my, one more look in the Meadowlands as we take you to this newcomer, the very mysterious, soft-spoken Waylon Mercy.
Who?
Waylon Mercy, he's a peaceful man. He likes his peaceful surroundings. It's peaceful outdoors, nobody around here to mess with him. The wind's out here feeling good on him. I'm just a peaceful individual who likes no problems. And that's the way things are going to be when I get to the WWF. It's going to be peaceful. You know what I mean?
You know, I usually can get a handle on people pretty quick. I don't get a feel for this guy.
Me neither, Gorilla, but when we come back, we will see the debut on Challenge of Savio Vega. Welcome back, everyone. Here comes Savio Vega. Looking forward to seeing this athlete. First time here at WWF Challenge, and Gorilla, I still don't know quite what to think of Waylon Mercy, but be that as it may, we know what to think of Savio Vega. Certainly, Razor Ramon does as well. It was on Mother's Day at In Your House when we first saw this Caribbean legend.
And then 2 weeks ago, we saw once again come to the aid of the bad guy.
Savio Vega looking forward to some upcoming events here in the WWF. I guarantee you fans, you get a chance to see this man live. Don't you dare miss it.
This guy, no stranger to the squared circle, a Caribbean legend, General.
The Brooklyn Brawler will challenge Savio Vega here this week. And
speaking of a good test for him.
Yeah, the Brooklyn Brawler against the man from South Bronx. Of course, the World Wrestling Federation next weekend. Some big events in the New York area, New York, New Jersey area. As Savio Vega opens up a lot of force on the Brooklyn Brawler. Brawler reverses the Irish whip, but no, my, nobody there. And Brawler's left shoulder just ran the ring post. And Savio Vega now going to try to make quick work of the Brawler.
Savio going to work on the injured left shoulder immediately with a nice arm wringer and now hammering away.
Going to come, ladies and gentlemen, another look at Skip and Sonny, the Body Donnas.
Can't wait.
I know you're big fans of theirs, aren't you, Gorilla?
Boy, I'm anxious to see what this Skip can do inside the squared circle. We can talk and know that.
Brawler missed that clothesline, but Savio did not.
He doesn't miss too many tricks.
Savio Vega and Razor Ramon certainly have a great relationship. They have a strong friendship, and I think these guys would be tremendous tag team partners if given the opportunity.
Well, they're going to be given the opportunity this Sunday on the Action Zone, but the competition's going to be stiff. Eli and Jacob Blue.
The big twins from the Appalachian Mountains. Jacob and Eli Blue to challenge Savio Vega and Razor Ramon. We hope you'll be with us on the Action Zone on Sunday as the Brawler's knee finds its mark to the midsection of Savio Vega. One thing I've noticed about Savio, Gorilla, he has a volatile temper.
Boy, he is quick. He's got a short fuse, and just like the bad guy, has the ability to absorb that punishment and still come back and teach you a lesson.
You know, as far as his competitive spirit is concerned, really reminds me a little bit of the WWF legend Pedro Morales.
Well, if he has half the competitive spirit of Pedro Morales, his future looks very, very bright.
Brooklyn Brawler trying to brighten his future with a body slam, and now the Brawler, well, he's taking a very uncharacteristic move for him going up top.
Took him forever to get up there.
But not quite as long to come down as Savio Vega slams him and then kicks him right in the face.
Roundhouse.
What a roundhouse kick indeed by Savio Vega.
Good night, nurse.
Tremendous move, and indeed Savio and the bad guy meet the Blue Twins on the Action Zone this Sunday. And folks, when we come back, we've got some important information for you from the WWE.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry of 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
Batman versus Superman. The Flash versus Wonder Woman. Who is the ultimate superhero? Find out in Justice League Task Force from Super NES and Genesis from Acclaim. You are judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is coming to all major video game systems June the 16th from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands.
Welcome back to Live Event News New York. How about a talk about a major development for this coming weekend? There are some great seats left at the respective box offices and all Ticketmaster ticket centers. 212-307-7171. Nassau Coliseum this Friday night. Madison Square Garden this Saturday night. Meadowlands Arena 1 week from tonight. And standing by is one of the most insightful and self-assured of my colleagues, Doc Hendricks himself. Doc, what is your take on the events of this coming weekend?
Well, my little chickadee, what this means is the World Tour de Force just got a whole lot bigger. This Friday in Nassau, this Saturday in Madison Square Garden, and 1 week from tonight in the Meadowlands Arena. A lot of people want to know, why would Shawn Michaels enter a battle royal? Well, think about this. Shawn Michaels won the Royal Rumble. Shawn Michaels' fuel to feed his ego is confidence. You win a battle royal, you've got confidence. And confidence is just what he's going to need when he goes to Madison Square Garden and steps in the 15-foot steel cage with Psycho Sid, his ex-bodyguard, the man that put him out. And when they get in there, they're going to be like two peas in a pot, and the peas wouldn't be jumping if the water wasn't hot. Then he's going to head down I-95 South to the Meadowlands Arena 1 week from tonight, team up with Bam Bam Bigelow for the first time ever against part of the Million Dollar Corporation, who is in sync, the Supreme Fighting Machine, comma, and his partner, Native American Tatanka. Now, what does this mean to Psycho Sid? Ha! Friday night in Nassau, he has to face Bam Bam Bigelow, who has no intention of winning this match. His intentions are injuring Psycho Sid and sending him not 100% into the cage match next Saturday in Madison Square Garden. Then after the cage match, if there's anything left of him, for the first time ever, he's got to go to the Meadowlands and face The Undertaker, the guy from the dark side. But keep this in mind. He put down Bam Bam Bigelow. He put out Shawn Michaels. From behind, you say? This is true. But the WWF champion Diesel, he put him down, he put him out, and he faced him eye to eye, man to man. Back to you, Chick-a-boom.
Chick-a-what? Tickets are available at the respective box offices and all Ticketmaster ticket centers. It's this coming weekend, and it all starts at Nassau Coliseum this Friday.
Hey, you're looking pretty good today.
I know. You're not so bad yourself.
You know, I'm talking to you out there. You know the family of two that takes up a whole 10-person sectional? I'm here today to show you what a body's supposed to look like. Notice the tricep area. No flabby skin. Notice the chins. There is only one. This is what a body is supposed to look like. This is perfection.
You know, we don't have to work at being this beautiful. We're gifted. We were born this way.
You know, we don't really have to work out like this to look the way we do. This is just to show you people what you could do if you had the motivation. Get up off that couch that is running back and forth the refrigerator all day. This is what you could do to get in shape.
It'll never happen.
So forget about it. You can never be as beautiful as us. I'm Sunny.
I'm Skip.
And we're the Body Donnas.
Okay, folks, right here next week, we'll see the wrestling debut of the Body Donnas. We'll
can't
see Skip
wait.
In action.
Well, I can't wait.
And ladies and gentlemen, this week on Raw, it's the final qualifying match for the King of the Ring tournament. What a matchup. brother-in-law's in action, Owen Hart and Davey Boy Smith.
Well, the current reigning king, the Rocket King, not too happy. He thought he should have been automatically, as the reigning king, put into the bracket.
And ladies and gentlemen, we'll update you on that situation right here next week as well, as we are counting down the days for the big King of the Ring tournament. For Gorilla Monsoon, I'm Jim Ross saying thanks for being with us. We'll see you next week, everybody.
The World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Bret Hart, are you getting ready for our big match at the King of the Ring, huh? Are you down in the dungeon with your old man Stu Hart wrestling around? Well, not me. I'm here in my royal stables with my prize horse, Prince. He's helping me get ready, and you know how he's doing it? He's letting me walk around in his stall with my bare feet. And I'm not going to wash these feet, Bret Hart, not until after our match. Not until after you've had to bend down on your hands and knees and crawl across that ring after I've beaten you. And then, in front of the entire world, Prince, he's going to have to pucker up those lips, and he's going to have to kiss my filthy, dirty, nasty, royal feet. It's going to be great.
Continental champion, Double J Jeff Jarrett is on his way to the ring, and of course Gorilla Monsoon, Jarrett the King Lawler, is on his way to the King of the Ring, and to face Bret the Hitman Hart.
And to kiss my foot, that's what a despicable individual, what a filthy individual the self-professed king Jerry Lawler is.
Lawler may have some heavy dues to pay in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, at the King of the Ring, if I know Bret the Hitman Hart, as the reigning Intercontinental Champion, Double J Jeff Jarrett, has taken over the squared circle.
Well, Double J, the current, of course, reigning Intercontinental Champion, you know, there might be a little dissension in the ranks now between he and the Roadie.
Well, there could be, because the Roadie is in the King of the Ring tournament, and Double J Jeff Jarrett is not, ladies and gentlemen. Again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being with us. I'm Jim Ross, alongside the Hall of Famer, Gorilla Monsoon. Thank you for being with us again. And folks, we've got an outstanding broadcast. We will be joined right here this week by the WWF champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
And also to join us, the new Beast of the East, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Plus, we will hear from the Boy Toy, the outrageous Shawn Michaels.
And then we will take you back to last Monday night on Raw with what everyone thought would be the final qualifying match for the King of the Ring between the reigning King of the Ring and his brother-in-law, the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. The exciting conclusion to that one.
We've got a great broadcast for you, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get started with Double J, Jeff Jarrett, the Intercontinental Champion. Double J being challenged by Kenny Kendall in our first event here on WWF Challenge. Follow an elbow tie-up. And Kenny Kendall's a fine young competitor.
He will push Double J to the max.
Kendall's in great condition, but so is Double J Jeff Jarrett. Jarrett tried to hip lock, but it was blocked by Kendall. And Kendall quickly counters Double J, sends him for the ride to the corner.
Oh, wow.
But Double J, the crafty ring rise.
Ooh, look at that. Second turnbuckle on the inside. Uses the ring to his advantage always.
Double J has a very busy schedule ahead of him. Nice snap suplex by the Intercontinental Champion.
Of course, the Roadie very conspicuous by his absence. I understand that Double J has given him some downtime in preparation for the very prestigious King of the Ring, of which the Roadie is one of the Elite Eight.
Indeed he is, and he will meet Bob Holly, Bob Sparkplug Holly, in the first round.
Come on.
And this capacity crowd, not too fond of the strutting of the reigning Intercontinental Champion, Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Irish whip to the far side.
Oh, look at that. Put his head down.
And a one, two, and a... Oh, almost an upset in this non-title event. Waist lock by Double J. And an atomic drop, compressing the spine there. Wow. And he took him down with a clothesline.
Boy, he is something, isn't he? He's quick.
Double J has a huge matchup in East Rutherford, New Jersey, tonight in the Meadowlands. He is a marked man by not only Razor Ramon, but Savio Vega as well. Of course, Double J and the Roadie responsible for it, taking out the 1-2-3 kid who will be back in action in the next few weeks. And I'll tell you, I'm impressed by Kenny Kendall.
Boy, I am too. Not very often you see Double J making these kind of mistakes. And hey, when you're in there with someone that's a superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation, just one of those mistakes will cost you the match, but look out.
Well, Kendall's made a mistake right here. Found himself in a precarious spot on the top rope as he suplexed right off the top turnbuckle. And Double J, of course, the master of the figure four leg lock.
And we're going to see it. Going to work now, softening up that left leg.
Kendall has that knee braced, his left knee braced.
There it comes.
From the spinning toe hold position, setting down into that figure four leg lock.
It's too late to get out now.
He's talking to his roadie, and indeed it is over. Kendall submits. Double J, Jeff Jarrett wins it by submission.
Well, Double J is still claiming to be the world's greatest entertainer. He hasn't proven that to us yet, Jim Ross.
We're still waiting on a singing performance by Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Look at him strut.
Come on, give me a break.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, our colleague, the mayor of Merchandise Land, the czar of t-shirts, is standing by. Barry, take it away, my friend.
Hey, Jim and Gorilla, thanks a lot. I'm backstage. You know, I was running around looking for my Mad Caps. I'm going to show you something. Not only can this game be played anywhere, it can be played on top of a garbage can. Take a look. I'm here with Duke the Dumpster and the Mad Capper. Guys, can you do me a favor and just hold up for just 1 second so I can tell everybody, please, about the Mad Cap collection.
Okay,
I'll be done in just a second. Folks, if you dial 1-800-TITAN-91, you are going to get a chance to be the first person on your block to own a complete set of Mad Caps. All 66 Mad Caps in one complete collection. But that's a pretty good deal for only $25. But you know what else you get? Take a look at this. This is an 18-karat gold-plated slammer. This is the only place in the U.S. that you can get this slammer. It's not available anywhere else. An even better deal for $25. But you know what else you get? Take a look at this. This is the brand new neoprene mat that the game is actually played on. And you know what? You also get one other item, and I'm going to show it to you right now. Take a look at it. The Just Slam It Zone t-shirt. 1-800-TITAN-91 gets you 66 mat caps, an 18-karat gold slammer, the neoprene board, and the t-shirt. 1-800-TITAN-91. Back to you guys at ringside.
Okay, Barry, thanks very much. A great gift idea there, Gorilla.
Boy, it certainly is. I know my grandkids would love it.
Ladies and gentlemen, still to come, Gorilla Monsoon and Al talk to Big Daddy Phil Diesel, the WWF champion. And we will also hear from his best friend, the boy toy, Shawn Michaels. Book to go away. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take you back to this past Monday night. Gorilla and I had the opportunity to call one of those exciting matchups that we have seen in a long, long time.
Boy, talk about a classic confrontation. The current reigning King of the Ring against his own brother.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. Well, the World Wrestling Federation World Tour de Force, what a hot weekend. Two nights ago at Nassau Coliseum, the 20-man over the top rope battle royal. Last night at Madison Square Garden, the epic cage match between the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Psycho Sid. The Heartbreak Kid was victorious. And if Psycho Sid hasn't been through enough already, tonight at Meadowlands Arena in the big finale, Psycho Sid meets The Undertaker, and they say The Undertaker feels no pain, but Psycho Sid is determined to change that.
It's too bad, Diesel, that you're still sitting at home, recovering and nursing your wounds. I only wish that you could be at the Meadowlands Arena tonight and see the look of surprise and then the look of terror on your face when my man, Sid, destroys and puts away, finally and once and for all, The Undertaker. Then he'll come for you, and you, Undertaker, who have been a thorn in my side for so long now, I have finally got the man who will put you away.
See, Undertaker, think about it. You're a person who feels no pain. You'll rise to all occasions. Do yourself a favor. Call Diesel
Ask him about the pain. The pain that you will suffer from the master, the ruler of the world.
But does Sid have what it takes to rule the Netherworld? And hey, does the Undertaker have a body bag big enough to fit Psycho Sid into it? After all, the Undertaker has been very aggressive lately in competition. Speaking of the Undertaker, I arrived at my news desk this morning and there was a tape that he left behind for me. He asked me to air it, so ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the Undertaker.
Oh, yes, Psycho Sid, we're just hours away from when you walk down the aisle at the Meadowlands and look face to face with the Undertaker.
Sid, the time has come. The end is in sight. And with one swing of this right hand, the end will consume you. And if you see it coming, you're already gone.
You know, Gorilla, thinking back to the King of the Ring, what a matchup between Owen and Davey Boy.
Boy, that was a classic again. President Jack and his infinite mercy made this match between Lex and Yoko. It's going to be another beauty.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, don't you go away. It's Bam Bam Bigelow. He's next. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Ross and Gorilla Monsoon back with you. And that man indeed is the beast from the east, the 390-pound Bam Bam Bigelow.
And a different kind of beast of the east with a lot of scores to settle of the dead with the entire million-dollar man and his corporation.
Fire indeed will be shooting from the fist of Bam Bam Bigelow as he joins forces with the incomparable WWF champion Big Daddy Cool Diesel at the King of the Ring in what most certainly will be a tag team war. Yes!
Oh, boy!
He's got fireworks shooting from that big ring.
Well, he doesn't need a whole lot.
You go away. We will be back in 30 seconds for Bam Bam Bigelow.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
You are judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is coming to all major video game systems June the 16th from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands. Batman versus Superman. The Flash versus Wonder Woman. Who is the ultimate superhero? Find out in Justice League Task Force from Super NES and Genesis from Acclaim.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry, 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. The bell has just sounded. It will be Reginald Walker challenging that man, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Bam Bam looks in great shape.
Man, he is ready to go. And of course, he and the Diesel certainly have huge, huge scores to settle at the King of the Ring when they face Psycho Sid and Tatanka. Little cheap shot there by Reginald Walker on the break.
You know, Bam Bam, of course, right now, one of the dearest friends of the champ, Diesel, along with, of course, Shawn Michaels. And what better friend could you want than that?
Well, we're going to be talking to the WWF champion in just a few more minutes here in the program. Side headlock. And Bam Bam went south with Reginald Walker with that suplex. Great power display by Bam Bam Bigelow. It's unfortunate on many fronts regarding Diesel's injury to his elbow. Of course, that was at the hands of Psycho Sid. That
he almost got him.
The thing I was going to say, Gorilla, is that Diesel and Bam Bam have not had the opportunity to get their tag team strategy down. Diesel has been immersed in physical therapy, getting ready for the King of the Ring.
Well, he certainly has that, but how ironic is it, Jim Ross, that it was Psycho Sid who not only put Diesel, Shawn Michaels, but even this guy. Oh, wow, did he hit hard. Bam Bam with that power bomb of his on the show for a little bit as well. What's he trying to do, eliminate everybody?
It seems to be that way, as Reginald Walker certainly trying to eliminate Bam Bam Bigelow. Certainly our first opportunity to see Reginald Walker here on WWF Wrestling Challenge, and he is making quite an auspicious debut.
He is put together.
Big, raw bone, powerful individual. Certainly doesn't seem to be intimidated with the vaunted reputation of the beast in the east, Bam Bam Bigelow.
And of course, let's not forget when Bam Bam was a corporate member, he and Tatanka were the biggest hopes of the Million Dollar Man to bring some gold in the form of the tag team championship belt into the corporation. And we all know what happened at the Royal Rumble.
What a clothesline right there. Yes, Bam Bam and Tatanka were very close in winning. Oh, another headbutt right to the ribs. The WWF Tag Team Champion.
Oh, there he goes.
That's Bam Bam now. We'll go up top. Remember this man, ladies and gentlemen, 390 pounds. Asbury Park.
Oh, there, macho, that's it. Forget about it.
Driving
lights out.
That head right into the ribs. And Bam Bam Bigelow wins it. At the King of the Ring, and what a tag team tournament that our matchup that's going to be. And now, ladies and gentlemen, joining us here in the arena, back in the locker room area, the incomparable WWF champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel. And Diesel, let me tell you, my friend, it's great to see you once again.
How are you doing?
Very good. Thanks very much. And really, we've been missing this guy.
You know, Chad, you really look good. Obviously, you have tremendous recuperative powers. And I know that you got one of the top physical therapists in the entire country looking after that elbow. We've gotten all kinds of reports from all kinds of people. I want to hear it, Chad, right from your own lips. What kind of shape is that elbow in?
Well, Gorilla, right now, I think that what they're claiming it is day-to-day. I'm on a day-to-day basis. I'm trying to get it approved by the World Wrestling Federation doctors to let me come back to action as soon as possible. Well, I guarantee you one thing. I will be a King of the Ring.
Diesel, I think that's the one thing that everybody wanted to know. So you will definitely be ready for a war. We've been calling the war. Don't you think it's going to be our street fight environment when you meet the team of Psycho Sid and Tatanka with your pal Bam Bam?
Yeah, without a doubt. I've been sitting at home listening to an old James Brown album called Payback. And when it comes time, it's definitely going to be payback time. I think Bam Bam's got a score to settle with the Million Dollar Corporation. I've definitely got a score to settle and some payback for Big Sid.
All right, champ, we look forward to seeing you in Philadelphia at the King of the Ring. Take care of yourself. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear these comments from the Million Dollar Man, of course, along with Tatanka and Psycho Sid. Listen to this.
You know, Diesel, that's great. I mean, you did a fantastic job of rehabilitating that elbow. And I tell you what, I'm so proud of you. I've got a present for you at King of the Ring. And here they are.
That's right, Big Daddy Cool. You're a little worried that your injury hasn't healed. Well, when Big Sid gets done with you, you're going back to rehab. And Bam Bam, guess what? It's going to be 2-on-1.
Gee, think about it. If the case was like this, if we were type of guys that might feel sorry for something like that, yeah. But we're not. Think about that, Bigelow. You and Diesel have got to face us. And you are going down.
Well, it's no laughing matter, Gorilla.
He's completely gone.
Absolutely. What a dangerous tag team matchup at the King of the Ring. What a matchup it will be, ladies and gentlemen. And when we come back, it will be the WWF Challenge debut of Skip and Sonny, the Bonnie Donnas. The Bonnie Donnas will be with us when we come back.
Hey, everybody. Guess who's here? It's us. This is Skip.
And take a look at our competition this week. This guy's so skinny, he eats a Cheerio for a hula hoop, huh? This guy can tread water in a garden hose, do you understand me? Lift a weight, eat a steak or something, buddy.
Hey, Skip, it smells so bad in here. The odoriferous emanation coming from this building is so unbelievable. I don't think anybody's taking a shower.
Showers. I'm not even
going to
need one after this match.
What is it with these two, Jim Ross? These are two very annoying individuals.
They certainly are. And remember, she's Sonny and no, he's Skip and she's Sonny.
They are.
Let's get it right. Boy, I'll tell you. Talking about, I thought Tony Little and Susan Powder, those ridiculous infomercials.
Well, they're annoying, too.
Pain in the fanny. These guys take the cake, I'll tell you that. Side headlock, it's John Smith. I think you can probably hear John Smith being introduced by the Fink earlier. Well, Skip and Sonny had too much to say. We're seeing them for the first time here on WWF Challenge. No, my, nice move there.
Well, they look to be in great shape. Well, oh, a few jumping jacks. It's going to take a little bit more than that to make it here in the WWF.
Well, we certainly hope that Diesel continues his physical therapy, his rehabilitation. We want to see him in great shape with the King of the Ring.
Well, I was happy to hear right out of the champ's mouth that, oh, look at this.
Right off the top rope. I don't know what to call that maneuver, but it was very effective.
As I was saying, Jim Ross, I was so happy to hear it right out of the champ's own mouth. He will be at the King of the Ring.
Very impressive victory for Skip. That's Skip. And of course,
and that's Sonny.
She's Sonny. Aren't they nice? Well, ladies and gentlemen, they're a little bit arrogant. Matter of fact, there's the blimp, Gorilla.
Well, take a look at that. They wouldn't let Yokozuna or Man Mountain Rock on the blimp.
Or you or me, either one. It's going to be all over the country. Washington, D.C., Baltimore, Maryland, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, let's take it down to Stephanie Wyatt. With more information in the Hall of Fame.
This year, the World Wrestling Federation will honor some of its legendary athletes at the second annual Hall of Fame dinner, which takes place at the Philadelphia Marriott Hotel in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, on June 24th. The distinguished inductees we have announced in recent weeks include the late, great Anthony Naraka, the Big Cat, Ernie Ladd, the Southern Belle, the Fabulous Moolah, and the Polish Hammer, Ivan Putski. This week, the hall proudly welcomes the late Ernie Roth, or the Grand Wizard as he was known in the squared circle. The Wiz was one of the most successful managers in WWF history and will be best remembered for his flamboyant ways, especially his unforgettable ring attire. Although Ernie was small in stature, he came across as larger than life in the World Wrestling Federation.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Oh, God, this place is going to be rough.
You want to talk about rattling the rafters and captivating a crowd? The fans are standing here as the boy toy, Diesel's best friend, Shawn Michaels, makes his way to the ring. And what a challenge awaits him as the King of the Ring. 330
pound armor. Boy, whoever wins that one could go out of the way.
Shawn Michaels, who was almost put out of the WWF permanently by the million-dollar man, Psycho Sid, is back, and he is back with a vengeance.
Talk about your new generation here in the World Wrestling Federation. Looking at this guy exemplifies it and says it all.
One of the greatest pure athletes I've ever had the privilege of seeing in the squared circle. And yes, he is controversial, Shawn Michaels.
Shawn, quite an impressive victory qualifying you for the King of Ring. Very impressive, beating King Kong Bundy. But now you will face a man from the Ted DiBiase's Million Dollar Corporation, the Supreme Fighting Machine, comma.
That's right. Manny, in the King of the Ring tournament, in the first round, Ted DiBiase's Million Dollar Corporation will be represented by comma, the Supreme Fighting Machine. Well, money bags and comma, Supreme Fighting Machine, I want you to take a good, long, hard look at the World Wrestling Federation sexiest, leanest wrestling machine. And at the King of the Ring tournament, I have already, as you know, been causing quite a bit of trouble for the Million Dollar Corporation. And Big Sid, you Neanderthal-looking Nimrod, I'll take care of you in due time. But as I said, at the King of the Ring tournament, I'll do what I have to do and take care of comma, period.
Okay, Shawn, in the event that you do beat comma, you will face either Mabel or Paul Bearer's Undertaker?
Well, you know something? As of late, they have been calling the Heartbreak Kid the giant killer of the World Wrestling Federation. And let's face it, all these fans have seen Shawn Michaels tossed around by all the big lugs in the World Wrestling Federation. I've got more frequent flyer miles than any stewardess on any airlines in the world. So getting tossed around and getting beat up by big guys is nothing new for me. The thing is, I never told you I was all that smart. I just told you I was the sexiest and the most talented. So whether it be Undertaker, Mabel, comma, anybody in the World Wrestling Federation, when it's all said and done, it's gonna be old HB getting crowned at the King of the Ring tournament, and then you, Manny, and all the fans of the World Wrestling Federation can just call Shawn Michaels the Heartbreak King.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what a challenge awaits Shawn Michaels.
I know.
I'll tell you something. I might not feel too bad if I'm putting a small razor on that man right there.
Well, he's got a lot of endurance. He's got a lot of guts. And boy, it's going to take somebody who's got that kind of equipment to make it to the King of the Ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Michaels, can he do it? We'll find out, and we'll be right back.
Uh-oh.
Black Reed is here, and there are a couple of the Undertaker's creatures of the night. Introducing Gomez and Morticia here this week.
Might be a little bit of formaldehyde flowing through those veins.
Rad Redford!
Those creatures of the night, fans of the Undertaker, are everywhere. And so is Rad Radford, seemingly. Rad Radford will take on Jerry Flynn and Gorilla. Have you been listening to your whole album?
Well, no, not really. Is that what's being played right now?
It's something comparable to that.
I'm not into that grunge rock thing, you know.
Well, Rad Radford, a big proponent of grunge rock, and scoops up Jerry Flynn. Ladies and gentlemen, let us quickly remind you of the WWF Superstar line. Hey, wait a minute. Jerry Flynn rolled up, and Rad Radford rolled right off his shoulders. Number 1-900-737-4WWF. Nice dropkick. Coming 24 hours a day, every day. $1.49 a minute, and kids get to the 18. Make sure your parents know you're calling. And the great thing about it is that the billing doesn't start until your option is chosen. Seven great options, many of them updated every single week. If you call option six, the Ross report, Lady Gorilla.
Oh, yeah. Hey, if you want to know what's going on, that's what you got to do.
And, of course, option five is the exciting WWF Interactive Challenge game.
Oh, boy.
And I think it may be safer for Jerry Flynn to play that right now than to be in there with Rad Radford.
You know, what a contrast. Only moments ago, we saw, of course, the boy toy Shawn Michaels.
Oh, no! You're not kidding. That's a big man going between the second and third rope with a shoulder block all the way to the floor, decimating Jerry Flynn here. Wow.
Throws him back inside. As I was saying, this guy looks like he hasn't had a bath in a month. Where on the other hand, the boy toy, so meticulous in the way he takes care of himself. What a complete
goal. Gut wrench into the slam. Yeah, I don't think Rapper's going to get any shampoo deals.
Highly unlikely.
Leg drop right across the face of Flynn. Radford showing a lot of offense here this week on WWF Wrestling Challenge. Again, thanks so much for joining us this week.
You think it has something to do with the weather in Seattle, Jim Ross, with all that rain and fog? And
double arm suplex.
Boom. Nice. Nicely executed.
I don't know. You know, I'm not that familiar with Seattle. I should take a trip up there sometime. I do watch Frazier. Slapped there by Rad Radford. And he is he's about as arrogant as we saw Skip and Sonny earlier. And both these two young people make your stomachs turn.
Well, they certainly do. And a lot of folks are going to be talking because coming up this Monday night on Raw, of course, that final matchup, hopefully, to find out who's going to take that last turn, who will face Razor Ramon in the first round of the very prestigious King of the Ring. Will it be Yokozuna, the co-holder of the Tag Team Championship belts, or will it be one half of the Allied Powers, Lex Luger?
Well,
let's not forget the Intrepid either.
That's right. I'm sure Yokozuna hasn't forgotten the Intrepid. And of course, as Gorilla pointed out, you have to win to advance. What a matchup this week on Raw as the Irish Whip sends Flynn in. And a spinebuster slam. Very, very nicely done by Rad Radford.
You know, I just like this guy very much, Jim Ross, but I have to say he's got some very nice techniques.
And there's a...
Oh, that's it!
Northern Lights suplex by Radford.
Look at the bridge!
Nice move. This guy's got some great wrestling skills.
Here's owner, Brad Woodford.
You know, Man Mountain Rock, who can actually play a musical instrument, is still to come this week. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick 30-second timeout. But when we come back, you're going to hear from a possible presidential candidate, Bob Backlund.
Oh, no.
He's going to talk about his domestic policy. You'll hear it in 30 seconds.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry of 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in stores now.
Gravity, cologne for men. More than a fragrance, it's a force of nature. You couldn't resist it, even if you tried.
The vacation is over, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm talking about all you people that have been sitting out on your couch for the last 10 years expecting the government to send you government dole each week and putting all the responsibility on all the hardworking people of America. The government dole is going to stop and you're going to be out on the streets looking for a job, and you may have to work for a dollar an hour, but you're going to have the opportunity of a lifetime to climb the ladder of success. Ladies and gentlemen, let's unite as a nation. We'll get rid of the 40-hour work week and dig in and increase it to 60 hours a week. Oh, no. We don't need holidays. Maybe there should be one holiday. We'll make it a national holiday. August 14th. My birthday.
Bob, why don't you sell some of those food stamps and get some professional help?
Boy, Bob Backlund still contemplating running for president of the United States. And, well, I don't want to get into my political views, but maybe it could be much more. I have no... Well, this guy right here is on heavy metal rock and roll. That is Man Mountain Rock, ladies and gentlemen. When we come back, we'll see this big man in action right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, Man Mountain Rock!
Get you one of those shirts too like that.
You can?
I got the double X. You only wear a 3 or 4X?
I'm a 4.
All right, I'll work on that for you.
Well, this guy's got tremendous wrestling techniques and abilities. tremendous amateur background.
Iowa State University was a very tough heavyweight there in the Big 8 Conference. Soon to become the Big 12 Conference, but be that as it may, the Brooklyn Brawler.
Oh, wow, what
a waist lock there. The brawler to survive. Best get this man Mountain Rock off his feet.
Easier said than done. In fact, it's the other way around right now. Put him up in a corner and leave him there. Don't trust the brawler. Oh, wow, that's what I mean.
Bob Backlund is observing this match, and we know that Backlund hates rock and roll. We mentioned he was going to allegedly confront and speak with Man Mountain Rock.
Well, he's in the entrance way right now, Jim Ross, and he'd defend it to the ring easily if he chose to.
The brawler trying to take a shortcut here to slow down Man Mountain Rock, and the brawler set to the post.
There he is. The would-be president of these United States.
Yeah, he was, he was campaigning long and hard to whomever would listen last Monday in Struthers, Ohio.
It was pitch black out. He was still out there.
Well, he doesn't know any better. That's why some folks call him Bob Dump.
Oh.
He has nothing to get there to look over the shoulder of the man that thinks he should be sitting in the White House. Maybe the outhouse, but somehow he belongs somewhere in some institution. There's no doubt about that.
You know, he thinks that everybody should just listen to classical music. Bach and Beethoven, that type of music.
It's not bad.
That's not what makes the world go round.
But you got to have a little diversity.
Sure. Plus, this guy is one heck of a musician.
Hard slam there by Man Mountain Rock.
Of course, Backlund wouldn't know one unless he fell on him and... He's getting much closer to the ring, Bob.
He likes that armbar submission right there.
That's it. He's got him.
He's trying to hyperextend the elbow, that armbar submission, and the Brooklyn Brawler says, I quit.
Very smart move by the Brawler. What a handful this guy is. 402 or 403 pounds of dynamite.
Man Mountain Rock will be rocking the house this week on Raw. And it should be a most interesting conversation if and when he has one with Mr. Backlund.
Well, Bob Backlund, you better be careful. You better choose your words very carefully, because this guy will make life miserable for you.
Folks, let us now update you on everything that's going on in the exciting World Wrestling Federation.
Welcome back to Live Event News New York. The World Wrestling Federation World Tour de Force, a huge finale tonight at the Meadowlands Arena. And let me tell you something, there are still, unbelievable as it is, some great seats left, but you got to make a phone call right now, or even better, go to the box office yourself. But I have the number for tickets, 212-307-7171. You talk about your great tag team matchups. Tonight, it is going to be the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, and the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, taking on the Million Dollar Corporation's Tatanka and Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine. And certainly, it has not been the weekend to be a member of the Million Dollar Corporation, according to Bam Bam Bigelow and the Heartbreak Kid.
Ever since the Heartbreak Kid took over the reins for Big Daddy Cool, I gotta tell you, this has been the greatest weekend of my life. You know what I mean. But I can't say the same for the Million Dollar Corporation. Big Sid, Moneybags, all of you, the whole grand bunch. Bam Bam and I are so sorry to have ruined your weekend, but I got news for you, it ain't over yet. Tonight, in the Meadowlands, Kama, Tatanka, Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, and the Heartbreak Kid are going to continue to make your life miserable. Million Dollar Corporation, your nightmares have just begun. I made a vow. Diesel made a vow, and the kid made a vow. The Heartbreak Kid, that's right. He's going to be breaking hearts. I'm going to be breaking heads in the Meadowlands. And that vow is, we are not going to stop until you are bankrupt and broke. Yeah. And DiBiase, you hang around ringside, and we just might get our hands on you, too.
And you wouldn't want that to happen, would you?
Ah, can you imagine it, New Jersey? Picture this. Bam Bam Bigelow is long last getting his hands on Ted DiBiase. He has to be at ringside with Kama and Tatanka. And hey, don't forget, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Bam Bam Bigelow have been watching each other's backs all weekend long. Bam Bam Bigelow, a former corporation member, what secrets has he been able to learn about Tatanka and Kama? You could see it all live, New Jersey, and I've got a special number for you. 201-507-8900. That's a special New Jersey ticket number. I suggest you make your call. It's all happening tonight. I wouldn't want you to miss out on any of the action. Oh, brother, tell you what, talk about a grand finale for the World Wrestling Federation World Tour de Force. We truly did leave the best for last, and it's all happening at the Meadowlands Arena tonight.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us here this week on WWF Wrestling Challenge. We have got an outstanding broadcast for you right here next week. We're going to show you highlights from Raw's confrontation involving Lex Luger and Yokozuna Gorilla. Will we get a winner?
Oh, boy, we definitely will. And we will also see next week the Supreme Fighting Machine, one of the Million Dollar Man's corporate members.
Kama will be with us, ladies and gentlemen. Plus, the outstanding tag team combination of Billy and Bart, the Smoking Gun.
And a special interview all lined up for next week with the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, and his newfound friend, Bam Bam Bigelow.
You know, Gorilla, it was great to hear from Diesel here this week. He indeed will be ready for the King of the Ring.
Boy, he is ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, thank you very much for inviting us in your home once again. We hope that you'll join us right here again next week. So to the Hall of Famer, Gorilla Monsoon, I'm Jim Ross saying so long, everybody.
The World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Be number one. Now I'm just three quarters, but the Smoking Guns are trying to get back to be number one after that big setback from Men on a Mission, who probably cost them the tag team title.
No question about it. They've got a lot of scores to settle, and the tag team situation, as always, hot and heavy here in the World Wrestling Federation. And you talk about big tag matches coming up, of course, next week at the King of the Ring, Big Daddy Cool, WWF Champion Diesel, taking his partner Bam Bam Bigelow, and they will face Psycho Sid and Tatanka. What a match that's going to be, if, in fact, Big Daddy Cool is ready.
That's certainly right. Oh, look at this nice maneuver here. Hook and Balog got caught.
Balog right in the middle.
Telegraph that move, and Billy Gunn's got him on the feet. He's going to stop his ball, Mike. Those big size 15 cowboy boots, and indeed Billy Gunn does stomp the head of Brooklyn Brawler, which probably would not affect the looks of him too much.
Oh, nice underhook there.
Mexican style on the track into a clothesline. Quick tags by the Smoking Guns. In comes Brother Bart. Gives another lariat-like maneuver, coming off the ropes, and drops a big, big elbow. Finds his mark right in the sternum.
right in the tear in his shirt.
You know, you mentioned Big Daddy Cool Diesel. That scar looked horrendous for Monsoon, not healing the way the doctor had hoped for. And certainly hope Diesel is not getting back inside the squared circle too soon at King of the Ring as Bart takes a big forearm there.
You know, of course, at that event, the WWF title not at stake, but the career, perhaps, of Big Daddy Cool is.
It certainly is. Bart got in there now with Doug Stahl. Don't know much about Doug Stahl, big rangy individual. Irish whip, that reversal in the middle by Stahl.
Oh,
blatantly telegraphed that move, took a boot, dropped to the hole by Bart.
Lack of experience, surely right there on Mr. Stahl's part.
Elbow planted in the back, into a hammerlock now. Well, these smoking guns, though. Ever since Bart gave up horseback riding, he's been a new man, really.
Well, both of them seem to be back 100% now from any kind of physical injuries they might have sustained at the hands of men on a mission. But, you know, if in fact, Stan, they do have a match and get by them, what are they going to look forward to? The Rocket King, Owen Hart, and Yokozuna, the reigning tag champs.
Yes, Yokozuna now weighing in at 641 pounds. You see Doug Stahl taking over there. Leg dropped across the bicep area. Yokozuna, in fact, was weighed on a cargo scale over in Singapore. It is, in fact, documented. Can you believe that?
Boy, can you imagine? I wonder if that was before or after lunch.
The question is there any tag team in the World Wrestling Federation who can possibly dethrone the tag champions of the Allied Powers, of course, come to mind. Jacob and Eli Blue, as we see Bart Gunn now up top, coming off double sledge into the deltoid area of Doug Stahl, and Doug Stahl had dropped him down to his knee.
You know, if you don't have that, if you don't have that continuity, that quick tag in and out, you're not going to be successful.
And speaking of continuity, you know, the big tag match at King of the Ring coming up. Big Daddy Cool Diesel, because of that injury, has not had any ring time with his tag team partner, and that worries me.
Whoa, look at that. Beautiful.
Beautiful double team maneuver there by the Smoking Guns.
Cover's
man leg is hooked. This one is in the history books. The Smoking Guns victorious here.
Most of them around. They did it in a hurry.
Still to come, Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine, a special interview there. Broadcast colleague, Vince McMahon with Bam Bam Bigelow and Diesel that we spoke about earlier. Hunter Hearst Helmsley and so much more. Don't you dare make a move.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. Last weekend, the World Wrestling Federation World Tour de Force. What a great weekend of World Wrestling Federation excitement. Friday at Nassau Coliseum, it was the heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels victorious in a 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal. Last Saturday night at Madison Square Garden, oh, it was an epic cage match between Shawn Michaels and Psycho Sid. Mr. Style himself, Robin Leach, was there. So was fashion designer Nicole Miller. But this past Sunday at the Meadowlands, it was great tag team action. The heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels and Bam Bam Bigelow taking on the Million Dollar Corporation's Kama and Tatanka. The two biggest observations from last weekend I had were that the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Bam Bam Bigelow washed each other's backs all weekend long, and what a friend to Diesel Shawn Michaels is, stepping in for his injured friend. And hey, don't despair, because the World Wrestling Federation is coming back to Madison Square Garden on August 12th. Tickets are available right now, but if you've been wanting to get away with the World Wrestling Federation, you'll certainly have a chance. You can go to beautiful Lake Kiyomisha to the Concord Resort Hotel, where the World Wrestling Federation will be live Thursday, June 29th, 1 week from this Thursday night. The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship on the line. The Allied Powers, Lex Luger and British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith, taking on Owen Hart and Yokozuna. If you saw Superstars yesterday, you saw Owen Hart and Yoko talk about this big match. But right now, the Allied Powers are here, and they've got something to say about it.
There's a new tag team in the World Wrestling Federation. The British Bulldog and Lex Luger, the Allied Powers, and we're coming after you, Yokozuna, the King of Hearts, Owen Hart, and we're coming after the World Wrestling Federation tag team belts. Isn't that right, Lex?
That's right, Danny Boy. The power and strength of the British Bulldog and Lex Luger are the Allied Powers in unison as one. From here on out, we're taking it one step at a time, going through one tag team at a time, till we get you and your belts.
Kiyomisha Lake will be rocking 9 great matches, 20-plus superstars. Tickets are available at all Boob Tube outlets in Monticello, Liberty, and Ellenville. And hey, New York, don't forget about the King of the Ring tournament coming just down the road to Philadelphia, the 8-man single elimination tournament, one of the most prestigious events of the year. There are tickets available right now, but you better move. That number, 215-336-2000. It's the 3rd annual World Wrestling Federation King of the Ring, and stay tuned, because later in the hour, I'll be back with a King of the Ring report right here on World Wrestling Federation Challenge.
Still to come. time World Wrestling Federation champion Big Daddy Cool Diesel and Bam Bam Bigelow and Bob Backman will campaign to abolish rock and roll music. Welcome back, everyone, to World Wrestling Federation Challenge. I want to take you back right now. Last Monday night on Raw, Bob Backman on the campaign trail as he considers running for president was... My goodness, you know, knowing Man Mountain Rock as I do, Bob Backman's presidential campaign trail may get derailed before he ever gets close to the White House.
Well, you know, if that issue gets really hot, I guess the way to find out about it is on the Superstar Line, Sam.
Certainly is. 1-900-737-4WWF is the number to call. It's $1.49 per minute. You must be 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling. And don't forget, billing does not begin until you choose your option. If you call this weekend, Gorilla, you can hear from Shawn Michaels, who will be facing Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine, who is in the ring right now.
What is that? Option number two,
that
right?
That is option number two, Shawn Michaels and Kama, the Supreme. You know what? If Kama gets past Shawn, you know, hypothetically speaking, he could face The Undertaker. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look out.
Speaking of The Undertaker, there you see that evil-looking black wreath being placed at ringside by the Creatures of the Night. Wow, I wonder if they call the Superstar Line. Who knows?
I can smell the formaldehyde from here.
Wow. Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine, squaring off now against a man who obviously knows some martial arts techniques himself, Jerry Flynn. And Kama, Gorilla, I've never seen Kama duck away from an opponent like this.
Very uncharacteristic.
Oh,
of him.
Look at that.
Wow.
Oh, carnal mistake.
Flynn turned his back. You can't do that.
Cannot do that in the World Wrestling Federation, or you will pay the price, as Jerry Flynn just did. And now going downstairs is the Supreme Fighting Machine standing, spinning neck breaker there. And another shot of those Creatures of the Night. I'm not sure if their heart's beating, bro.
Are they married?
You got me. Submission-style maneuver here, working that leg and knee joint.
You know, if things don't go Kama's way at the King of the Ring, it will be Shawn Michaels who will have to face either Mabel or The Undertaker.
Certainly will. Kama was distracted by the Creatures of the Night. Now Jerry Flynn opening up. Jerry Flynn now with the chance here on Kama, throwing those roundhouse kicks to the midsection, rib area, reversal center ring, and then Flynn takes one downstairs. Now firing away with the right hand is Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine, who is up around that 350-pound mark, Gorilla.
Boy, is he ever. And have you noticed that of late? Shawn, the boy toy, has been calling himself the Giant Killer.
Certainly has. Flynn now just took one hard in the turnbuckle. Shawn Michaels also called himself the Heartbreak King. Shawn Michaels obviously very, very confident, but you have to be going into King of the Ring to face three superstars the same night. Ooh, big back kick, finds its mark. Right in the sternum area, covers me.
Over. Well, indeed. If Kama can go all the way, Stan, he will be the first ever corporate king.
And Ted DiBiase would love to have any kind of goal the corporation, be it a title or a crown.
Wait a minute. He didn't even wait to get his hand raised. Now he's out there confronting the Creatures of the Night. Obviously, he's not afraid of them or the wreath.
He appears to be irritated, though, by that wreath. Look at those creatures, Rilla Monsoon.
Are they breathing?
They're spooky. Right now, I want to take you to an interview conducted by our broadcast colleague, Vince McMahon, earlier this week with Bam Bam Bigelow and World Wrestling Federation champion Diesel.
All right, gentlemen, it all happens next weekend. The WWF King of the Ring, the tag team matchup, when you pit your collective skills against those of Native American Tatanka and Sid prior to the King of the Ring. Bam Bam, you were very heavily involved in the Hall of Fame induction and ceremony. Yep. And prior to the King of the Ring, Big Daddy Cool, you're very heavily involved, along with a bunch of Hollywood all-stars in a celebrity softball game against the NFL players out in Oklahoma City, the benefits of which go to the Disaster Educational Fund. You're going to be pitted against the skills of Troy Aikman, Barry Sanders, Derek Thomas, many, many of the NFL stars, all of that leading up to the King of the Ring. Let's talk about tag team competition. More importantly, based upon the headgear that we see upon those craniums, it must be the year of the snow cone.
It is. They're nice, aren't they?
Very nice.
Bruce Willison is this.
Oh, yeah? Very nice, but down to business now.
Of course, my injuries put a damper on our preparation as far as where we thought we'd be right now, but, you know, Bam Bam is tagged with Tatanka as a team, and I've done some battle with Sid, so I know his weaknesses, and I believe, you know, Bammer knows Tatanka's weaknesses, so we've been able to watch some tapes and pretty much put a game plan together as far as executing it. You know, that's a different story.
All right, well, let's talk about the injury. Are you prepared, as we speak at this moment, to go into battle?
I've played with pain my entire life. I don't think this is anything different. It's sore, but there's no doubt I'm going to be there.
But as far as the doctor's advice, have you gotten clearance from the WWF officials yet? Have you gotten clearance to go into the ring?
No, not yet. It's day-to-day right now. I'm trying to fool them.
I see. Bam Bam Bigelow, how does this affect you, knowing that that you have, yes, as a partner, the WWF champion, but you have obviously, and he's less than 100%, let's be honest.
Well, you know, I think Big Daddy Cool at less than 100% is equivalent to Tatanka or Big Sid at their 110%. I've wrestled Big Daddy on a Monday Night Raw match where, I really seen the light and really realized why Diesel's the champ, you know, and, him being at his percentage and me being at my 110%, and what I know, and especially what I know about Ted DiBiase and his corporation, is going to play a big factor. You know, we're going in there confident. And like I said, we studied the tapes. We got a good game plan, and if we stick to our game plan, we should come out on top.
So mentally, you are unquestionably prepared. The only question, of course, is the physical part, and that answer will come very shortly now as we approach the King of the Ring. All I can say, gentlemen, is the very best of luck to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody, to World Wrestling Federation Action. Stan Lane, Hall of Famer Gorilla Monsoon. Nice to have you along as well. There you see Hunter Hearst Helmsley prepared to step inside the squared circle. And we'll remind you that Wrestling Challenge this week is brought to you by the U.S. Army. Learn to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. You know, Grill, I was just thinking back to the interview we saw earlier, as soft-spoken as the champ in Bam Bam were. It makes me think, you know, sometimes when people speak with soft and tender words, it's because they are prepared to have to eat their words later.
Well, you know, they're in a very precarious position right now. The champ, of course, with that injured elbow, you know, he's not even cleared yet by the WWF officials to participate at King of the Ring in that tag match. So, you know, how bad does that look for that team? On the other hand, paranoid, the psycho Sid and his partner, Tatanka, constantly working as a team, looking to get better and better, get more continuity. In the meantime, Bam Bam and the champ having to wait in the wings. Well, you know, you can watch films until you're blue in the face. You've got to step in there and face your opponents. I don't like the odds of the champ and the Bammer coming out on top of this one.
Well, your point is very well taken. And this Monday night on Raw, as you know, Sid and Tatanka will gain even more valuable ring experience as they take on the head shrinkers. So I'll tell you, in my opinion, it does not look good for Diesel and Bam Bam at this point. Nice front toehold there by Hunter Hearst Helmsley as he faces Barry Horowitz here. Ooh, front face lock into a hammer lock by Barry Horowitz. Barry displaying some of those match skills. Hunter Hearst Helmsley also very adept. Hunter Hearst Helmsley, Grilly, you know, had that wrestling tutor.
Well, not only that, he's undefeated here in the World Wrestling Federation, and not a whole lot of guys can say that.
He's a big, big, rangy individual as well. 6'4", about 260 pounds in superlative condition. But, you know, he's so stuck on himself. You have to wonder how he can wrestle so well with his nose up in the air all the time.
Well, you know, getting back to the big tag match, Dan, how often do you see the champ going into a match as an underdog?
A rare occasion indeed, and I keep thinking back to that wicked-looking scar on Diesel's arm.
Well, the scar is bad, the injury is bad, and he's putting himself in jeopardy.
Oh, nice maneuver here. Center ring, double reverse into a hip lock takeover. Hunter Hearst Helmsley Gorilla finds himself once again on the mat, courtesy of Mr. Horowitz. And Barry getting himself a pat on the back. He's proud of himself.
Unfortunately, ooh, that pat on the back is only 18 inches away from a kick in the pad.
An exchange of slaps, boom, a European uppercut, staggers Helmsley. Drop kick knocks him back as well. And Hunter Hearst Helmsley's never been controlled like this. And I've seen Barry Horowitz just got a leverage maneuver there. Face first in the turnbuckle. Now, Mr. Helmsley, open it up. Upstairs, downstairs.
Oh, boy.
Back upstairs. Fists are flying here. I'll challenge, and there's a European uppercut for you as well.
And one more thing, Stan. If the Beast of the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, thinks that he can carry the load, forget about it.
Oh, vertical suplex there. Snapped him right over. Well, Bam Bam Bigelow has vowed revenge against the Million Dollar Corporation, but if he thinks he's going to carry the load against those two corporate members, he is sorely mistaken.
Well,
Barry Horowitz a little sore himself right now, holding onto his head, just having been stomped and stomped good. And again, takes a stomp right in the head. Those big big polo riding style boots that adorn the feet of Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Hunter moves in now, but perhaps too soon. No, Hunter firing away. Big bolo shot to the back of the neck. Irish whip now to the far side. Goes Barry Horowitz. Takes an elbow right in the butt of the jaw. Hunter not electing to go for a cover here. Just basking in the...
Oh, was that a curtsy?
I think it was.
He hasn't even broken a sweat yet.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, here it comes.
Check this maneuver out here. This will be a face-first maneuver. Barry Horowitz straight down. This one's gone.
The pedigree got him.
Certainly did. Leg is hooked for good measure. Referee makes the count. And Hunter Hearst Helmsley can chalk up one more victory here in the win column on challenge.
You know, Stan, I don't like this guy, but he's impressive.
He certainly is. Although they don't like him. Ladies and gentlemen, the World Wrestling Federation blimp is making its way down the East Coast towards Philadelphia, PA, King of the Ring.
And Yokozuna won't be piloting it, that's for sure. It'll be in the Big Apple, New York City on Friday, June 16th. And then it goes on to the U.S. Open to watch the Hackers and then on to Fenway Park. And then straight to Philly for King of the Ring.
The World Wrestling Federation magazine presents the second annual World Wrestling Federation Hall of Fame induction ceremony. 7 new inductees will be enshrined next Saturday, June 24th, at the Philadelphia Marriott Marquis in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Honorees we have mentioned in previous weeks include Antonino Argentina Rocca, the Big Cat Ernie Ladd, the Fabulous Moolah, Polish Power Ivan Putski, and the Grand Wizard Ernie Roth. This week, the Hall of Fame is proud to welcome two more legends, the first of which is Pedro Morales. Pedro held the tag team title, the intercontinental title, and the WWF title, becoming the first Triple Crown winner in World Wrestling Federation history. And the Hall of Fame also welcomes the man with a taste for the turnbuckle, George Steele, who was aptly named the Animal. Words could not describe this legendary figure's manner in or outside of the squared circle.
Still to come, highlights of the final qualifying match between Yokozuna and Lex Luger.
And then we'll bring you up to date on the hot issue of the Kiss My Butt match.
Welcome back, everyone, to Challenge. Now, we are counting down the days to King of the Ring. Next Sunday, as a matter of fact, in that Kiss My Foot match. And, you know, Grillo, I've got to tell you, with the smile that's been on the face of Jerry Lawler, he seems overly confident for this match.
Oh, extremely overconfident. Obviously, something up that stinking sock besides that horrid foot. You can bet on that.
Next Sunday, the Kiss My Foot match will, of course, take place at King of the Ring. But to really get a whiff of this Kiss My Foot match and how it unfolded, we have to go back to the very first WWF In Your House.
You know, the number one rule for kings is never, ever let the peons see you sweat. But right now, I'm certain that even you noticed the perspiration popping out on my royal face. Well, it's from the revulsion that I am experiencing right now, because the stench from my own feet are about to do what no wrestler's ever been able to do, and that's knock the king to his knees. But that's nothing compared to what they're going to smell like when you, Bret Hart, have to pucker up and kiss him at King of the Ring. I can hardly wait.
You know, this Kiss Your Foot match is your idea, Jerry Lawler. And the fact that you're dreaming about me actually getting on my hands and knees and kissing that dirty foot, well, it's never going to happen. Picture this, you slimeball. After I pounded you into a pulp and you've kissed my feet, I'm going to take that same rotten, dirty, stinking foot, grab your ugly face, and they are going to make a real nice match. Jerry Lawler, I'll see you in the ring, you slimy, gutless rat.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. You are judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is coming to all major video game systems June the 16th from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands. Batman versus Superman. The Flash versus Wonder Woman. Who is the ultimate superhero? Find out in Justice League Task Force from Super NES and Genesis from Acclaim.
Gravity, cologne for men. More than a fragrance, it's a force of nature. You couldn't resist it, even if you tried.
In the ring, as you see him right there, Jacob and Eli Blue, the Blue Twins. Of course, Uncle Zebekiah in there as well, who raised the boys from mere pups set to take on Mike Corey and John Crystal and Gorilla Monsoon. I'm just thinking back to Jerry the King Lawler. You know, he smells so bad now he can hardly stand himself.
Well, you know, I think Vince McMahon has got his work cut out for him. He's going to have to find somebody else to sit next to him on Monday Night Raw, because Bret the Hitman Hart is going to clean the clock of one King Jerry Lawler. Maybe we've seen the last of that disgusting... Well, I can't even call him a human being. Because
easy, easy there. Easy, big guy. Tie up, pedal and elbow, center ring now. The blue twin, one of them, I don't know who it is, having a clue. They're both identical. Big hip lock takeover. You know, the blue twins will be headed to Kayamisha Lake, Gorilla Monsoon. Won't be long. We're less than 2 weeks away from totally live World Wrestling Federation action in the beautiful Concord Hotel up there at Kayamisha Lake in the Catskills.
June 29th is the date, and I hope that self-professed...
Whoa!
Jerry Lawler shows up. I'd like to drown him in that lake.
What a card is going to be. Three titles will be up for grabs. And oh, look, you see that? Wow. To the outside with the momentum and authority. Certainly, I hope that youngster is not injured on the outside. Landed hard.
You know what I mean? You know the match I'm looking forward to, Stan?
What's that?
I'm looking forward to Alundra Blaze after that nose surgery and everything, coming back and what she's going to do to Bertha Faye.
Certainly is. And the return to action of the 1-2-3 kid who has been sorely missed here in the World Wrestling Federation with his high-flying and martial arts tactics.
Oh, look out.
Oh, to the turnbuckle hard. Hooking the foot now.
Come on. Oh. Get in there, ref.
John Crystal just being hammered there in the corner.
Well, and these guys we're looking at right here, Stan, are going to be in for a lot stiffer competition come the 29th of June at the Concord Hotel, because they'll be in there against Billy and Bart the Smoking Gun.
Well, the tag team situation really heating up here in the World Wrestling Federation. Tag was made right there. You know, speaking of tag teams, the big main event in Kayamisha, of course, the title will be on the line. Tag team gold, the King of Hearts, Owen Hart, and his tag team partner, the 641-pound Yokozuna, take on the Allied Powers right there in the Concord Hotel. Oh, look.
Well, he doesn't have that title anymore, Stan. He's not the king anymore, you know.
Yeah,
King of the Ring tournament is over, and Owen Hart wasn't any part of it, so he's out to lunch. But what a matchup that's going to be. Lex and the Bulldog against the Rocket King, Owen Hart, and Yokozuna. I'm going to go up there just for the heck of it.
Bam Bam Bigelow will also be on hand in Kayamisha as he starts to... Ooh! Spinning neck buckle right there, nicely executed. Bam Bam Bigelow trying to totally decimate and bankrupt that million-dollar corporation. Bam Bam Bigelow to face Native American turncoat Tatanka. All that in Kayamisha.
I know you're going to be there because Skip and Sonny are going to be there.
Yeah, Sonny, she is hot. And action heating up here.
Ooh,
is a series of big, big, heavy elbows with authority being dropped on the back of the helpless opponent there in the center ring. Is that Crystal or the other one? I can't even tell, they've been so beat on.
Really, does it matter?
I guess not.
I don't think so.
Jacob and Eli Blue having their way here on challenge, but I dare say, as Gorilla said earlier, the smoking guns at the Concord Hotel, it'll be a whole different ballgame, Gorilla.
Don't forget, folks, mark the date down on your calendar right now so you don't forget. It's June 29th. That's just, it's close to 2 weeks away, but you'll want to get your tickets early if you can, because this thing is going to be the SRO sign. We'll go out early, standing room only.
Yeah!
What? Are you talking to me?
Better not be talking to me.
Yeah!
You're more his size, Gorilla. I'm hiding behind you, big guy. Another quick tag is made here. What? I tell you, you gotta tip your hat to these guys. The Blue Twins are kind of like a 10-speed bicycle. They haven't even used all their gears yet. There you see a double stomp right to the face of John Crystal. He goes down hard.
Well, Stan, you know, if you look at the books, the only blemish on these guys' records, of course, is the defeat at the hands of the Allied Powers.
That's correct. Look, off the top rope.
Look at that.
Oh, Crystal just got billed off hard. You don't see that maneuver very often. To the ropes now for more momentum, and a big, big knee finds its mark.
Right
in the sternum. This one is over.
Oh, mercifully.
Easy work for Jacob and Eli Blue.
Of course, they could suffer another defeat in the Catskill Mountains on the 29th of June.
Certainly could. As we said, less than 2 weeks away from totally live World Wrestling Federation action. When we return, we'll see highlights of the final King of the Ring qualifying match between Lex Luger and Yokozuna. Stan Lane, Gorilla Monsoon back with you. Let's take you right now back to last Monday night on Raw. It was the final qualifying match for the King of the Ring tournament. Yokozuna made his way down to ringside to face. There you have it, Yokozuna, the final superstar to qualify for the King of the Ring tournament. He's now part of the Elite Eight that takes part in that prestigious tournament. It all happens next Sunday.
Hi, folks. It's me again. Tell you, time is running out. The third annual WWF King of the Ring is just 1 week away. Can you believe it? That's next Sunday, June 25th, from the Core State Spectrum in Philadelphia, totally live. And at 7 p.m. Eastern and 4 Pacific, it's exclusively on pay-per-view. We have got some fantastic matchups to talk about, so let's get to it. As you just saw, the bracketing for the first round of the King of the Ring tournament was completed last Monday night on Raw when Yokozuna gained the final slot in the tournament with a victory over Lex Luger. The first round matchups alone are incredible. The 515-pound Mabel will take on The Undertaker. Then the Supreme Fighting Machine Kama will take on the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels. So in the second round, you could wind up seeing The Undertaker take on Kama. Then again, Shawn Michaels won the Royal Rumble, so he definitely has the conditioning it takes to win three matches in one night. Shawn could meet The Undertaker or Mabel. If Razor Ramon gets by the gargantuan Yokozuna, he could get his hands on the roadie in the second round. Well, then again, the two biggest men in the tournament, Yokozuna and Mabel, could wind up meeting each other in the finals. Are you confused? Whew. I tell you, the possibilities are practically endless.
King of the Ring tournament superstars filled to the brim this year. The Elite Eight of the World Wrestling Federation going at it. And in the first round, Kama, you got the HB Kid, the leader of the pack, if you will. And if I get through you, you know something? I may have to face either Mabel or The Undertaker. Oh my, when it's all done, you're going to call me the King of the Ring and the World Wrestling Federation's giant killer.
Which one of these Elite Eight superstars will have what it takes to win three matches in one night and call himself the King of the Ring? We'll find out next Sunday, June 25th at 7 p.m. Eastern and 4 Pacific. And remember, the only way to see it is on pay-per-view. Now, courtesy of WWF Superstars, it's Henry Godwin taking on Bret the Hitman Hart.
Considering the stench of the slop in the hot farmer's bucket,
Bret Hart may be getting accustomed to what's going to happen in approximately a week when he faces Jerry Lawler in that Kiss My Foot matchup.
Well, I can't wait, but that footage that we just seen on the video
was repulsive.
Repulsive, I would suggest that the King and his little pony Prince were making television history. And you talk about history. Later on in the program, I've got even some better footage that might show you what that man right there, Bret Hart, will be doing in 1 week at King of the Ring, courtesy of our buddy Alpo Montoya.
And the Hitman Bret Hart making one individual, one youngster, a very, very happy young man.
The Hitman ready to lock up with Henry O'Godwin. Wait a minute. Resorting to the fisticuffs. Yeah, sure, your hand was open. Bret Hart pounded by Henry Godwin. Henry Godwin. Scooping up. Bret Hart slapped him down to the canvas. You wonder whether or not Jerry the King Lawler, who is in attendance, had anything at all to do with the strategy in this matchup. Godwin, the money hole!
He missed it by a foot!
Robert, Bret Hart now, hammering away. Bret with a succession of hard right hands, trying to set up the hard farmer. Bret Hart with a bit of momentum, continuing to pummel away.
Well, there's no need to be callous.
And Bulldog down to the canvas.
Bret Hart with a cover. He gets one, two, and a cover.
No, he does not get Henry Godwin. Godwin, very, very resilient. Tremendous competitor, and Bret Hart snaps him down to the canvas. He does not get it. Very competitive matchup here as Bret Hart only a week away from perhaps the most embarrassing, the most humiliating match he has ever participated in, the Kiss My Foot match. Truly a one of a kind ever. And Bret Hart's long and illustrious career and off the rope. Bret now with a yet a third cover. Still can't put away the big odd farmer from Arkansas.
Arkansas. What a competitor this Henry Godwin is.
Oh, yes, he is, but a poised Bret Hart would have hooked the leg. He's unmentally focused. You see, he should have hooked the foot. He's being too footloose and fancy free.
Wait a minute, Bret.
Hey, what's that? Is that you?
What do you mean?
That's smell.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in stores now.
Preferred stock. The extra smooth cologne for an extra special man. Preferred stock. What preferred men prefer. From the House of Stetson.
Long on chocolate flavor, short on fat since 1896. Tootsie Roll, 66% less fat than most of the 20 leading chocolate brands.
Hello, people. It's Waylon Mercy again. Out here enjoying this peaceful surroundings. Enjoying nature. Enjoying these insects. Enjoying this worm. But you know something? I enjoy worms. But I don't enjoy worms crawling on me. Just like when I get in that wrestling ring, I don't like wrestlers touching me. And I definitely don't want them crawling on me. And if they do so, I'll tell you what's going to happen. They're going to get smooshed just like this worm.
The way I see it, we all have two sides. For me, there's a side that's ruthless, punishing, relentless. The part of me that will do whatever it takes to completely demolish the competition. Then, there's my bad side.
It's a jungle out there. Lead poisoning is lurking to get your little ones. Lead paint chips for them to nibble on. Lead dust for them to breathe. So keep little ones away from peeling paint. Wash their toys and wash their hands before they eat. And damp mop often. One more thing. Have young ones tested for lead poisoning. Take care of your pride and joy. Get ahead of lead.
I love my cars, keeping everything inside running just right. But what about the outside? You got to keep it right, too. How? Easy. You know, the, better get Mako guys.
Mako, always a great value. Right now, you can have it all with our Smart Pack. Start right with our Value Prep Pack. A great presidential finish. And get our ultraviolet sunscreen all for one low price. Now, only $279.
You want it done right? Call Mako. America's smart choice.
Julio Cruz is a man with mental retardation. All his life he felt like he was chasing the pack. Now he's chasing a dream. Julio is training for the largest sports event on earth in 1995. The Special Olympics World Games in Connecticut. The World Games need volunteers and sponsors. Call now and make the world believe.
Ladies and gentlemen, next month the Special Olympics World Games get underway once again, July the 1st through the 9th in New Haven, Connecticut. And for the past decade, the World Wrestling Federation has been a proud sponsor of this tremendous event.
Boy, I can't wait for the games to begin because we're dealing, folks, with world-class athletes.
We certainly are, and I can't wait for next week right here on Challenge. What a week it's going to be. Psycho Sid will be here with his tag team partner, Native American Tatanka, in action as they prepare to head to King of the Ring to face World Wrestling Federation champions Big Daddy Cool Diesel and Bam Bam Bigelow.
Of course, on everybody's mind, is Big Daddy Cool going to be ready? We'll find out. And also, to join us next week, the Grim Reaper himself, The Undertaker, and perhaps the Creatures of the Night.
Plus, we'll hear from old Stinkfoot himself, Jerry the King Lawler, as he prepares for that Kiss My Foot match. If you haven't done so already, pick up your phone, call your local cable company, join us on pay-per-view for King of the Ring. For Gorilla Monsoon, I'm Stan Lane. So long, everybody.
The World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Look, up in the sky. Is it a bird?
No.
Is it a plane?
Well, a form of.
No, it's the WWF blimp, and it's headed to Philadelphia for the King of the Ring this Sunday night.
Defeated the Head Shrinkers, and I think their game plan is there for all to see. No doubt, if and when they separate Diesel from Diesel's tag team partner Bam Bam Bigelow, Tatanka and Psycho Sid will indeed focus on the right elbow of Diesel. It will be a great challenge, perhaps the greatest physical challenge the WWF champion has ever had.
And if Bam Bam thinks for one moment that he can carry the load for the entire team, well, highly unlikely.
Gus Katarakis and Buck Quartermain to challenge these two representatives of the Million Dollar Corporation. Good shoulder block there by Katarakis, surprising Tatanka, who reverses the Irish whip. And Tatanka,
wait a minute!
He's got Katarakis up on his shoulders and falls away with that slam.
End of the trail is one. Oh, he could have had him right there.
Tatanka, no doubt, could have pinned Katarakis with the end of the trail if he had chosen to.
I don't think they're done sending the message yet.
Well, this is more deliberate than Western Union, that's for sure, as Buck Quartermain comes in. No doubt that Big Daddy Cool Diesel and Bam Bam Bigelow watching the broadcast this week as they want to scout their opponents, and Psycho Sid certainly is anxious for this Sunday night's King of the Ring showdown in the City of Brotherly Love. High elevation. What a back body drop.
Just got over there. Almost came down head first.
Quartermain went through a couple of time zones there before he struck the canvas. And there's the first tag to Psycho Sid.
You know, if the champ thinks, Jim Ross, that he's going to be safe on the outside when he's not in the square circle, well, I wouldn't bank on that either.
See, it taking shots at whatever moves in this contest.
You know, not only is he going to have to watch Sid and Tatanka, but who knows how many other corporate members are going to show up.
Well, look at this move right here.
Oh, boy.
Thought it was going to be a razor's edge.
A helicopter.
And Quartermain was almost as high as the WWF blimp.
He's done.
One thing that we must again reiterate is that Bam Bam Bigelow and Diesel have never, oh my, what a choke slam, have never joined forces. They've never been in a tag team match yet.
Well, this will be their first and perhaps their last. But, you know, the theory remains. Will Tatanka ends all, here comes Powerbomb on the way.
This is the move right there that caused the extensive surgery to the right elbow of the WWF champion Diesel. At the top of the nails, Kentarakis coming in.
Referee's losing control of this one in a hurry. Boy, are they sending a strong message?
And they certainly are. This is a, the point of cliche, a well-oiled machine, no doubt about it.
Another bomb on the way. Oh.
Two power bombs, and you see the results. This could be the WWF champion Diesel and the near 400-pound Bam Bam Bigelow.
They covered it both.
This Sunday night at the King of the Ring, a very impressive and
here
devastating victory for Psycho Sid and Tatanka.
And Sid.
Million-dollar man could be very, very happy when Sunday night is all over.
Let's take another look, Gorilla, some of the action just moments ago.
Well, this was a cardinal mistake made by the youngster earlier on. He didn't have the momentum, and he got dumped right on the back of his head. And then the spinning helicopter. Wow, how impressive is that?
Ladies and gentlemen, our young colleague, Manny Garcia, is making his way to the ringside to try to have a word with the million-dollar corporation.
Ted DiBiase, an impressive victory this week. But come this Sunday at King of the Ring, two different guys, Bam Bam Bigelow and Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
Listen to me! We will destroy them!
Well, wouldn't surprise me.
They've got a great deal of confidence, and they may be the odds-on favorite for this Sunday night. Let's take a look at this incredible tag team matchup taking place this Sunday night at the King of the Ring. Let's take it back to Monday Night Raw last
DiBiase, let me tell you this. I promise you one thing. I promise you and the corporation, you are all going to deal with me.
At the very first WWF In Your House, Bam Bam and Diesel did form a tag team and did accept DiBiase's challenge.
And we aren't going to quit until a corporation is bankrupt.
Was far from healed. Meanwhile, Sid and Tatanka have been gaining valuable tag team experience and a lot of confidence going in to this Sunday night.
Well, well, another impressive victory against nobody. You know something, boys, it's not going to be that easy come King of the Ring. Just around the corner, a lot of questions are going to be answered. Questions that I think you guys might think you've got a little bit of an advantage. Think maybe Big Daddy Cool is not going to be at 100%. Hey, King of the Ring, I don't care what kind of shape I'm in, you're going to get 100% of me. And if this thing's bothering me, you're never going to know it. Sid, you powerbomb me. Sid, you chokeslam me. You hurt me then. Did you know it? Did you know it in the ring? No. I got heart, big boy, something you don't have. And at King of the Ring, you're going to see Big Daddy Cool and Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, at 100%.
And that's right. Nobody knows the corporation better than Bam Bam Bigelow and you, Tatanka. And you know, Ted DiBiase, I just hope you're ringside too, because I would like nothing better to have me or Big Daddy Cool get our hands around your neck. Because in the Spectrum, in the King of the Ring, you boys are going to learn one big lesson, and that's not to mess with us, because we are not going to stop until you are bankrupt and broke.
Hello, all you people. It's old Waylon Mercy again. As you can tell, I'm out here at the park, around the picnic area, waiting for all the people to come in. Surely after a while, they'll be out here with their children. with her fried chicken and potato salads and some hot dogs. Surely some hamburgers to go along with all that stuff. And the kids will be running around here having a good old time. And then after a while, the kids will get on the parents' nerves, and the parents will start yelling and screaming. And then load up everything, put the children in the back daggum seats. Then they'll go home, and then they'll tell all their families and friends what a great time they had at the park and what a great picnic it was. Well, let me tell you something. Waylon Mercy knows how to throw a good picnic. And when I get into the ring in the WWF, I want to show you people what a picnic is all about. You know what I mean?
How would you like to see that guy walking down Manhattan Road? Did they get fit in New York City?
Boy, he fit right in. But I'll tell you this, Mr. Mercy, if you think it's going to be any kind of a picnic for you here in the World Wrestling Federation, you are rudely mistaken.
Wherever you're watching us here today, ladies and gentlemen, I want to wish everyone in New York City, especially watching us on Fox 5.
Fox 5, hot item.
Hope you're having a great weekend here on the King in the Ring weekend. Of course, the WWF looking forward to a huge event. Without a doubt, the biggest event of the summer will be in Madison Square Garden on Saturday night, August the 12th. And seats are available and going rapidly, we understand, at all area Ticketmaster outlets, including the Madison Square Garden box office. And I'll tell you something, after what happened the last time in the Garden, Shawn Michaels really battered and fried, I'll tell you that, when he won the cage match over Psycho Sid Gorilla, but then in the cage, he was triple teamed by the Million Dollar Man, Tatanka, and Psycho Sid, and Shawn Michaels has not been a happy camper since.
Well, not hard to understand why, Jim Ross. You know, that's why I thought in the first place, that's why they were assembling the cage, to keep all those guys out of there from getting involved, but obviously it didn't get the job done.
Well, Michaels and his best friend, the WWF Champion Diesel, will be in tag team action.
Maybe they'll be able to settle some of the scores. Oh, look at that.
Well, they're looking forward to meeting the Million Dollar Corporation in the Garden. And I know that WWF officials are anxious to see what happens at the King of the Ring. And then I understand that right here next week, we'll have more information, perhaps the complete lineup. Oh, nice move there by Adam Bomb on the Saturday night, August the 12th, Madison Square Garden Spectacular. It will start at 8 o'clock on Saturday night, the 12th. And as we said, get your tickets early for this one.
You know, all the officials, Jim Ross, and the WWF waiting for this spectacular to be over here this weekend because it's going to have ramifications on that August 12th date.
No doubt about it. Adam Bomb right off the top of the clothesline.
Good night, nurse.
Great move there by Adam Bomb. And Reginald just got knocked right out of his boots just about.
Boy, what a rising star this gentleman is here in the World Wrestling Federation. Just one of the many luminaries whose career is skyrocketing.
Well, one thing we know for sure, Daryl Strawberry will not be coming to the WWF. He's a Yankee now.
He certainly is, whether he can hit or not.
Whether we like it or not. Adam Bomb. He's got a pretty good arm. Maybe Mr. Steinbrenner should take a look at this guy. They need some relief help.
Boy, oh boy, talk about class one athletes. You're looking at one right here. There goes a bomb up into the balcony, and another one about to explode somewhere. Wherever this guy is, sooner or later, he's going to get a shot at the most coveted prize in all of professional sports, the WWF title.
We hope all of our fans in New York City and the surrounding area will join us tonight on pay-per-view. And remember, the Garden comes up Saturday night, August the 12th.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
You are judge, jury, and executioner. Judge Dredd is coming to all major video game systems June the 16th from Acclaim. Take the law into your own hands. Batman versus Superman. The Flash versus Wonder Woman. Who is the ultimate superhero? Find out in Justice League Task Force from Super NES and Genesis from Acclaim.
Preferred stock. The extra smooth cologne for an extra special man. Preferred stock. What preferred men prefer. From the House of Stetson.
I'll bet you peons are wondering just exactly where you are. Well, I thought I'd invite you on a personal tour of my little dungeon of torture. Take a look at this little jewel. I'd like to invite each and every one of you to have a seat sometimes. Or over here. Can you imagine the torture of being locked into this, huh? But that's nothing compared to the torture that 8 men are going to put themselves through in the King of the Ring tournament just to be called an imposter king, because I'm the real king. Take a look at this. Look at the name here. It's called the Fall Brett. Our folly board, it was a forerunner to the guillotine. Ooh, and it's so appropriate because of the name. It reminds me of you, Bret Hart. And it reminds me that you're going to have to fall down on your hands and knees after I beat you at King of the Ring. And you're going to have to kiss my royal feet. Take a look at this rack, Bret Hart. Do you see this? I promise you would rather be on the rack than have to kiss my feet. Oh, sure, I got my boots on now. That's because I'm letting those corns and bunions and calluses fester and grow until the King of the Ring. And in front of the entire world, you're going to have to pucker up and kiss my stinking royal feet.
Your torture chamber, Lawler, will be the core state spectrum.
Ladies and gentlemen, still to come, The Undertaker. Welcome back, everybody. This week's WWF Challenge is brought to you by Pet Boys. Quality parts, accessories, and service come to Pet Boys, America's automotive super center.
Well, there's a good look at Alba Montoya looking to get back on the winning track after being humiliated. You know, that right there gave a whole new meaning to the term ptomaine poisoning.
Jerry Lawler forcing Aldo Montoya to kiss Lawler's corroded and festering feet. Exactly what Lawler hopes Bret the Hitman Hart will do this Sunday night at the King of the Ring.
You know what I didn't understand, Jim Ross? Why Aldo didn't just chomp down and bite off that big toe?
He may have been in shock.
Well, that could be too.
The smell and the stench may have been so revolting that he didn't have all of his faculties about it.
I understand he's gone through several gallons of mouthwash since then and still can't get the taste out.
Bill Payne challenging the ultra-quick young superstar from Portugal, Aldo Montoya. Aldo, hip-lock takeover. Boy, this kid is very, very quick. I felt so badly for him after the denigrating experience that he had with Jerry Lawler on Superstars that we took a peek at just a few moments ago.
Well, certainly had to be degrading, no question about it, but I can't wait for this Sunday night because Bret the Hitman, oh, wow, what a drop. Here.
Great drop.
Hitman is going to once and for all end this situation. He's tired of being humiliated. He's tired of being made a fool of, and hey, I would not want to be in the horrible, stinking shoes of Jerry Lawler.
Aldo Montoya just moments ago with a very nice armbar takedown. You know, one thing about this is that if Lawler gets disqualified or he decides to take a hike and gets counted out, he loses, right?
That's correct.
And if you lose, you kiss the winner's feet. So Lawler can't avoid the issue here.
Well, on the other hand, too, Jim Ross, you got to look at it this way. Bret is so upset right now with Lawler that he could lose his cool. He could be disqualified.
You know, that's an excellent observation. Bottom line here is that the Hitman best keep his cool in this matchup.
No question about it. And they're telling me, Jim Ross, that Lawler's feet now stink so bad that the other night at a hotel, they inadvertently triggered off the smoke alarms.
Well, I hadn't heard that one. Bulldog headlock.
This one's over.
Indeed it is, Aldo Montoya with a here is your very winner, decisive victory here this week. Ladies and gentlemen, still to come, Akushi, The Undertaker, Mabel. We don't have Connie Chung, but we've got the news.
Thank you.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand, and tonight is the Regal King of the Ring, the event we've all been waiting for, happening at the beautiful Core State Spectrum in Philadelphia. And get this, there are still a few great seats left, and if you make your move right now, you might be able to snag one. I think you're going to want to. Plenty of action, nearly 3 hours of it. The number for tickets, 215-336-2000. And talk about great action. How about 2 weeks ago at Madison Square Garden, the epic cage match between the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Psycho Sid. There were a few moments there I wasn't sure what was going to happen, but the Heartbreak Kid was victorious. I tell you what, if you thought that night was something else, well, guess what? On August 12th, the World Wrestling Federation returns to Madison Square Garden. That's right, you heard me correctly. And get this, what happens at King of the Ring will directly affect the card at Madison Square Garden. As a matter of fact, World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney and the World Wrestling Federation officials will meet next week to sign contracts, and tune in next week because I will definitely release that card to you. As a matter of fact, tickets for the New York event are available right now at 212-307-7171. Now, if you can't get to King of the Ring and you absolutely positively can't wait to see the World Wrestling Federation live until August 12th, well, I've got good news for the New York area because we've got four hot nights of action coming to you in July. You heard me correctly. We will be live at the Westchester County Center in White Plains, New York on July 8th. Then we go to the Sayreville High School Gym in Sayreville, New Jersey, Friday night, July 14th. We'll then go to Mount St. Michael Academy in the Bronx on Saturday, July 15th. And we'll end it all at the Patchogue Medford High School Gym in Medford, New York on Sunday, July 16th. It's four hot nights of action in July with superstars alike of the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, King Kong Bundy of the Million Dollar Corporation, and Mabel. And get this, the creation of Devastation, Atom Bomb, will be in action. That's right, all you Bomb Squad members, you better come on out and give him your support. Japanese sensation Hakushi will be there, one of the most high-flying superstars in the entire World Wrestling Federation. He's a great one to see live in action. The Prince of Pranks, Doink the Clown, and Razor Ramon's childhood friend, Savio Vega, who hails from the Bronx. There's nothing like seeing the World Wrestling Federation live, especially when it comes to your town. The music, the lights, the action. It's the best. And hey, while the kids are out for summer break, why don't you bring them on out to see the World Wrestling Federation live? And don't you go anywhere, because later in the hour I will be back with a King of the Ring report.
Welcome back, everyone. It's King of the Ring weekend. Jim Ross and the Hall of Famer himself, Gorilla Monsoon, back with you. And there you see Hakushi making his way to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, let us remind you, a lot of big things going on this weekend on the WWF Superstar Line, the number 1-900-737-4WWF. It's only $1.49 per minute, and the billing doesn't begin until you choose your options. And I must remind you, kids, you got to be 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling. Owen Hart will join Stan Lane this weekend, Gorilla, this Sunday, and he will provide expert analysis. You know, he was the King of the Ring champion last year, and they're going to talk to all the King of the Ring competitors and all of the winners this Sunday, beginning at 6 o'clock Eastern Time.
Well, that should be most interesting indeed. It'll be interesting to get the insights of the current reigning King of the Ring, but, you know, this, I'm a little bit suspicious, Jim Ross. You know, he's going to be in the same building in the Core State Spectrum when that event is going on. I think that the Rocket King Owen Hart has been bought and paid for by Jerry Lawler.
Well, you know, that's exactly what I think a lot of folks might think. And also, that leads to a little bit of suspicion regarding Hakushi and Shinja. They are not involved in the King of the Ring tournament this weekend.
They're going to be there.
And I've got more on that on option six. Why is Hakushi and Shinja going to be in Philadelphia this Sunday night? We'll tell you about that on option six on the WWF Superstar Line. We'll keep you updated all weekend on this situation. Bell sounds and we're ready to go here as Hakushi will be challenged by the Floridian Bob Cook.
You know, Jim Ross, since this guy was humiliated at In Your House by the Hitman, he hasn't been quite the same.
He has been a very aggressive, a very angry man. It was not a pleasant Mother's Day for Hakushi.
Well, it certainly wasn't, and a good reason why, because, hey, I know I've been to Japan on a number of occasions, about 50 to be exact, and when you lose face in front of your own people, that's a big deal in the audience.
Bob Cook trying to score an upset here on the martial arts expert known as the White Angel.
That Cook's about 260 pounds.
Yeah, he's got that great right hand. Remember this guy?
Oh, yeah.
Big time right hand. Cook is a veteran, as we said, from Florida.
Ooh, nice suplex.
Cook was going to roll over in the lateral press. Cook having some words with Shinja. You know, they call him the White Angel to do the Hakushi.
Oh, look at that move.
Nice move there. He didn't look so much like an angel when he tried to assist Jerry Lawler and did so.
Well, he did.
Successfully at In Your House. If it hadn't been for Hakushi and Shinja, Lawler would have never had a chance against Bret Hart.
No way, shape, or form. And instead, the final outcome is that in the record books, it says that Lawler beat the Hitman not once, but twice.
Bob Cook trying to fight back here, and Shinja goes to the face.
Well, I won't say he beat him three times.
Well, I'll tell you something. I have never seen Bret Hart more intense and more focused, nor have I ever seen him more upset than right after he lost to Jerry Lawler on Mother's Day in Syracuse, New York.
But how do you justify the fact that Lawler is so confident, Jimmy?
That is really, really suspicious. As Hakushi goes upstairs and comes right down on Bob Cook with that splash. That's what really has me baffled. Why and how can Jerry Lawler?
He knows something that we don't know.
Absolutely. How can he be so confident? He's got to know something we don't know. And there's got to be a plan. Is it Owen Hart? Is it Hakushi? Is it somebody else that we don't know about?
Or both.
Well, I tell you, the deck could really be stacked for Bret the Hitman Hart this Sunday night at the King of the Ring as Bob Cook continues to compete, but falling a little bit short here against the very talented and very athletic Hakushi. Irish whip to the far side.
Uh-oh, look out. Round off coming up.
Nice handspring elbow by Hakushi.
I'll give him a 9.5 on that.
I think that's fair and very effective, to say the least. It's going to be interesting to hear what The Undertaker has to say about meeting Mabel this Sunday night, and we will hear those comments.
And if he gets by Mabel and Kama can get by Shawn Michaels, they would meet in the second round. How about that?
And The Undertaker would love that.
Oh,
well, what do you think about a Shawn Michaels-Undertaker matchup?
Love it. Look at this.
Well, look at this great athleticism right here. Tremendous balance, high-risk maneuver, and that torpedo-like headbutt found its mark.
Look at that! Shinja said no! It's not over yet. I want you to dish out some more punishment.
Well, that's a little sadistic if you ask me.
And the chant goes out from this capacity crowd. We want bread. Well, I got news for you. I'm not too sure that Shinja or Hakushi wants it.
Another great move right off the top rope. You've got to be so very impressed with the athletic ability and the balance of Hakushi. And not unlike Governor Pete Wilson, here's Bob Backlund with some political words of wisdom.
I have an astronomical amount of abomination rock for every single thing that you stand for. From here all the way down to the tip of your toes. Look at your hair. Look at your arms. Look at your body. Look and listen to the music that you play for the world and especially for the youth. I've got to save the world. I've got to destroy you and your attitudes and the effect, the deleterious effect that you have on our society is so destructive. You're gonna rot. You're like a toothache to a society, and I have to destroy it.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in stores now.
Gravity, cologne for men. More than a fragrance, it's a force of nature. You couldn't resist it even if you tried.
Long on chocolate flavor, short on fat since 1896. Tootsie Roll, 66% less fat than most of the 20 leading chocolate brands.
Uh-oh. It's getting considerably colder in here, Jim Ross.
It is a little chilly.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and doctor.
By his manager,
is that your hand on my shoulder?
Absolutely not. Hold on to your wallet.
I think Mabel could be in big trouble, too.
Well, you know, you bring up a very interesting point here. We know that this Sunday night, The Undertaker
who for the first time has entered the King of the Ring tournament, will meet Mabel. We also know, Gorilla, that the Undertaker's favorite offensive maneuver is the Tombstone Piledriver. And there's no doubt in my mind that at some point in the contest, the Undertaker will be able to affect the Tombstone Piledriver, but will he be able to execute it on a man that weighs 68 pounds.
Well, that's a difficult task, no question about it, but that shows you just how prestigious this King of the Ring tournament is.
Here, the Undertaker, one of the creatures of the night, wants to be king.
We know he likes to use the chokeslam. Will he be able to utilize that offensive maneuver against a huge, huge Mabel, who we will see a little bit later in this hour?
Well, I know this for a fact, Jim Ross. One of Mabel's favorite moves, of course, is that belly-to-belly, and he can do that to the Undertaker.
This should be a most interesting conversation with our colleague Manny Garcia as Paul Bearer and the Undertaker move to the center of the ring.
Manny looks a little uptight.
I don't blame him.
Undertaker, it's no secret to everyone in the World Wrestling Federation that the Undertaker is interested in any championship. As a matter of fact, this will be the first King of the Ring tournament for the Undertaker. What is so special about this particular King of the Ring? Mr. Bearer, Undertaker, before you get to Kama, you must face one of the most feared competitors in the World Wrestling Federation today, Big Mabel.
All you have to do, my friend, is look at all the giants that my Undertaker has left laying. I don't think Mabel will be any problem at all.
I don't agree with that.
Time for the body count to continue. Mabel, the night that I qualified for King of the Ring, your chances of becoming King Mabel, the night of a lifetime, became the night you have to fight for your life.
Qualify, put away to the reigning Intercontinental Champion.
That's right. And that wasn't easy.
A fight. A fight you can't win. And as far as you're concerned, Kama, if you make it to the second round,
ooh, there they are. The creatures of the night.
You will pay for the violation of my sacred urn. And you will pay dearly.
How many creatures of the night will appear at the Core State Spectrum?
And if you don't advance, you can rest assured the end is at hand. And come on. If you can see the end coming, you're already gone.
Hey, if he doesn't advance, that means one thing, and the Undertaker does, he would have to pay Shawn Michaels.
Mabel, rest in peace.
I think Manny should have had a boom mic.
Well, I'll tell you something. It is going to be quite interesting this Sunday night. Will the Undertaker be able to advance over Mabel? And then who will he face? Will it be Kama or will it be Shawn Michaels? We'll talk more about it. Take a look at Mabel. What we welcome back, everybody, and the man that will face the Undertaker this Sunday night, the King of the Ring. Big Mabel is on his way to the ring.
Well, he wants to be referred to after Sunday as King Mabel. Well, he's big enough, he's powerful enough, but
Does he have the cardiovascular condition to take him through three superstars? I don't think so.
Ladies and gentlemen, our dapper colleague, the mayor of Merchandise Land, is standing by.
Who?
Barry DeVinci. Take it away.
Guys, thanks a lot. We got the King of the Ring t-shirt here. And boy, I'll tell you, I'm still shaking. Mabel just went by me. Who knows? Maybe he'll be King of the Ring. This shirt's available in small, medium, large, extra large, and of course, double XL. King of the Ring's coming up this Sunday night. I'm going to take the shirt and turn around and show you the back of it real quick. Here it is, live on pay-per-view from the Philadelphia Core State Spectrum. And by the way, gang, if you order the t-shirt, you get the Bob Backlund for President Biden absolutely free. 1-800-TITAN-91. Back to you guys.
All right, Barry, thanks very much. A great offer there on the King of the Ring shirt. And the
button has to be a collector's item.
Absolutely. Huh. So was that Dewey for President button back in the 50s.
Boy, was it ever. David. You got one, I got one, I know that.
My grandpa willed it to me.
He did.
David Haskins has got a huge task awaiting him here.
Too big a task.
Mabel, 568 pounds. If you're wondering how we arrived at that weight, he was weighed recently on a cargo scale.
Singapore.
In Singapore, that's exactly right. The same time that Yokozuna was weighed. You just don't hop on some, bathroom Toledo on that one.
Well, it's a good thing it wasn't one of those digital talking scales. That
it would have said, get off.
No, it would have said, one at a time, please. Ooh, look at that.
Mabel's got a lot of agility for a man his size. And again, as we... Oh, my!
Ooh, holy mackerel!
And he turned Haskins inside out.
360 in midair by the youngster. And for all intents and purposes... Uh-oh.
The creatures of the night, big fans of The Undertaker.
Which one's alive?
Well, they're both a little pale.
Oh, wow.
Nice roundhouse kick there by Mabel. Again, think about it, folks. How can The Undertaker turn Mabel upside down and execute the tombstone pile driver? And that one right there. That may be the move that takes this man to the throne.
Well, at least in the second round anyway.
Here's your winner, Mabel.
Have to get that crown, it has to be made larger to fit on that cranium.
He's thinking about what it would be like to be known as King Mabel. Manny Garcia making his way to the ring once again. And Manny, take it away, but whatever you do, be careful.
The time for the talking is done. There will be some major upsets this year. And yes, when the smoke clears, King Mabel will be born.
Well, he claims he's got a bigger following than Mike Tyson.
Well, Tyson had a big celebration in Harlem. Maybe King Mabel will as well. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a lot more still to come. And this guy's on a tear. When we come back, he's undefeated. He's Jean-Pierre Lafitte. And we'll have him next. WWF certainly proud to be a part of the Special Olympics as a continuing sponsor.
Well, for the past decade now, Jim, we've been... behind that worthy organization, and hey, why not? We're dealing with class one athletes.
Lisa, we are part of the opening ceremonies in New Haven on July the 1st. And ladies and gentlemen, let us take this time to remind you that the WWF magazine, there you see it, is available now on newsstands nationwide. Some interesting information in the magazine regarding this Sunday night's King of the Ring.
Boy, there certainly is. What a collector's item that is.
And Jerry Lawler will not be a part of the opening ceremonies on July 1st.
What a despicable person.
The undefeated Jean-Pierre Lafitte being challenged by John Sanowski.
You know, just to show you how tough the competition is here in the World Wrestling Federation, this guy, undefeated, did not get a bid for the King of the Ring, but I guarantee you he will next year.
Oh, absolutely. This man is destined for stardom, no doubt about it. He has got great athletic skills, does Pierre a bona fide mean streak. And let me tell you something, folks, this is one of the most powerful men in the entire World Wrestling Federation.
Boy, you can say that again. We talked about that upper body power, comparable, only to somebody like, oh, look at this, like Davey Boy can do this.
Tremendous strength here. Look at the military press
That's just phenomenal power. Tremendous strength on display by Pierre. Ooh. 10 or 12 reps of that live body weight of John Sanowski.
Dropped him like a bad habit.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're excited about our arrival in Philadelphia this weekend. On Saturday night, the Hall of Fame induction ceremonies, a very impressive list of inductees and a very impressive list of presenters, including my esteemed colleague, Gorilla Monsoon, who will be inducting Pedro Morales.
Boy, what an honor that is for me. Hey, going to be some other big guns on it as well. Your longtime pal, Cowboy Bill Watts.
Be inducting Ernie Ladd. Going to be a great night, a great weekend for all of us as Pierre has just about decimated Sanowski here.
Had him all tied up there just a moment ago. You know, Danny Davis, you can ring the bell right now.
Yeah, Sanowski may not be able to defend himself here. This Pierre, you've got to be so impressed with this guy. And as we said, there's a double arm suplex into a modified version of the power bomb. He is very aggressive.
Oh, look at that.
And has great confidence.
He did. That movement right there says I'm going to give him the old keyhole right now.
Pierre climbing up top.
He's loading it up.
Loading up the cannonball, no doubt about it. Here it comes.
Oh, wow.
That is the move that may take him to championships right here in the WWF.
Obviously, soon to become a luminary here in the World Wrestling Federation. Pierre Matisse.
Very, very impressive. No doubt. An upcoming young superstar in the WWF as we take you to the news.
Hi again, everyone. Stephanie Wyand here. The most prestigious night of the year is nearly upon us. That's right. This Sunday, June 25th at the Core State Spectrum in Philadelphia, it's the third annual King of the Ring Spectacular, 7 p.m. Eastern and 4 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on pay-per-view. So don't miss out on your chance to be a part of the action. Call your local cable company now or you'll lose your toehold on all the incredible action, because the Kiss My Foot match between Jerry the King Lawler and Bret the Hitman Hart is going to happen. Can you imagine it? The loser of the match must crawl across the ring to the victor and kiss his foot. This is the ultimate in humiliation. And you have to understand that whoever loses this match will be branded for the rest of his career. Jerry Lawler has not washed his feet in weeks. Obviously, his own stench has not gotten the better of him, because he had the audacity to nose into the Hitman's business last week on Superstars. Incredibly, Bret Hart already had odoriferous opposition in the hog farmer, Henry Godwin. Let's take you back.
Terrorizing by the foot. He's going to kiss his foot. Get it over with.
No, from behind.
Henry Godwin with a clothesline that leveled Bret Hart.
Boy, Bret's got soul.
Get it.
Listen. The conspiracy, ladies and gentlemen, unfolding here on WWF Superstars.
Come on, look at him.
Tell you, Bret the Hitman Hart is having a terrible time lately. He gets another chance, though, to take on the hog farmer from Bitters, Arkansas this weekend on the Action Zone. Who knows? Maybe having to deal with Henry Godwin's down-home scent will be good conditioning for the Hitman's confrontation with Lawler.
I can say one thing about Jerry Lawler. He's forced me to deal with things. The fact that I've had to deal with him boasting about beating me once is bad enough. And then I had Hogman. I had him beat. But Jerry Lawler came out, showed his ugly little face, and I ended up chasing him back to the dressing room, and I missed him by this much. Jerry Lawler, I'm glad I missed it, because I want you in the ring in the I Kiss Your Foot match. That's what I want. That's what I got. I got you. And after I ram my foot down your throat, I'm going to take your own dirty, stinking foot and ram it right with your ugly face. Jerry Lawler, I'll see you in the ring.
The Kiss My Foot match is this Sunday night at King of the Ring, live from the Core State Spectrum in Philadelphia, exclusively on pay-per-view. Stay tuned, because when we come back, Jim and Gorilla will have more on the King of the Ring.
How much do you pay for a minute of long distance overseas?
I'd say about $1.65 a minute to Australia.
$2 a minute?
It's very expensive.
Introducing Sprint Sense International. Simply great rates to anywhere in the U.S. and now to anywhere in the world.
Call now and get these simple low rates. Just 50 cents a minute to these countries in Europe. 65 cents to these countries in Asia. 70 cents to Japan. And just 10 cents a minute for all your out-of-state calls in the U.S.
You can save on both international and domestic.
65 cents a minute to Korea?
That's a great deal.
Here's an even better deal. Call now and you'll get a world-class bonus. Up to 100 minutes of free international calling. Sprint will even switch you for free.
Bye.
50 cents la minute pour la France. No gimmicks, no nothing. No so wenig. Wow.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Get Sprint's low international rates and up to 100 minutes free. Call now 1-800-293-2766.
Now is the perfect time to reserve the all-sports package at Mount Airy Lodge, Pocono Gardens, or Strickland's. Enjoy swimming, tennis, boating, beautiful accommodations, fabulous food, and a special price. Right now, this $110 value is yours for only $75. Call 1-800-441-4410.
All you have to do is bring to your love of everything. Beautiful Mount Airy Lodge.
Eight noble World Wrestling Federation superstars in a grueling single elimination tournament. The WWF King of the Ring. Witness the coronation live June 25th on pay-per-view.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you can't be with us in Philadelphia, indeed, pick up your telephone and call your local cable company and join us on pay-per-view this Sunday night. You promised us your predictions. Who do you like in this eight-man single elimination tournament?
Well, Jim Ross, the Elite Eight has not been decided yet. So far, we only got an Elite Seven, but I kind of like a guy like Shawn Michaels because he's got all the tools necessary to become King of the Ring. But hey, don't discount the Grim Reaper either.
And a big tag team matchup. Boy, is this going to be physical when the WWF Champion Diesel and the Beast in the East take on Psycho Sid.
Have been honing their skills the last few weeks here for tag team competition while the Champ and the Beast in the East been on the sidelines nursing their injuries.